Picture perfect Sunday afternoon in Pittsburgh, 53 degrees, not expecting the wind to play a huge factor here. Moments away from the opening kick, let's send it over to Evan Washburn. Evan?
Line under Jack Del Rio, his staff, and obviously some new personnel. This Raiders team seems far from the group that started last year 0-10, but there's some key members of that team that are having a driving force towards this turnaround, including Khalil Mack, who we spoke to yesterday, and he said he hasn't put that losing behind him. He thinks about it every day, reminding himself we cannot go back to that. And guys, while it's still early, a win today would not just put them farther away from their losing pass, it'd be one step closer to the postseason.
Matt, Evan, they are over 500 this late in a season for the first time since 2011, when they were 8-7 entering week 17. Pittsburgh has won the toss. They've elected to receive. They have a new returner. You might be familiar with him, Jacoby Jones, a Super Bowl standout with the Baltimore Ravens. Used to be a thorn in the side of the Steelers. Now he is one of them, replacing Dre Archer, who was released. Janikowski on the kickoff. It bounces over to Jones, mishandles it initially, and Jones takes it just across the 20-yard line. Taylor Mays makes the play on special teams, and that's where Pittsburgh will open up with Ben Roethlisberger. Last week, three interceptions. First time he's done that in a game since 2011.
Yeah, both Roethlisberger and offense coordinator Todd Haley told us that they have challenged Martavis Bryant to be more physical at the line of scrimmage, to get off that bump and run, get down the field in order to come up with some of those big plays that have been missing last week against the Bengals in that 16-10 loss.
We asked Roethlisberger, was he rusty? He said, look, I don't use rust or a knee brace as an excuse. I just have to play better. I have to make better throws. They'll go empty on the first play from scrimmage. Out of the gun. Roethlisberger throwing. It's a drop ball. Martavis Bryant, the intended receiver. Asante there defensively. Incomplete.
Yeah, a good safe throw by Roethlisberger right on target on the hitch route as ball goes right between the one and the zero. Nico Thorpe on the loose coverage that time for the Raiders.
Dime package here for Oakland. Eighth drop pass of the season for Pittsburgh. Roethlisberger is on time. Antonio Brown is hit at the 27. It's a 6-yard pickup. Starting offense for Pittsburgh, Marcus Gilbert will have a challenge dealing with the likes of Khalil Mack today. Backs and receivers, Heath Miller last week in that loss. 10 catches, 105 yards. Fourth 100-yard receiving game of his career. Woodson is down for Oakland.
Yeah, he made the tackle on Antonio Brown playing in this game with a bad shoulder, and he could not even get off the field. Immediately signaled to the sideline. Watch that right shoulder. Right into the leg, and he twisted his arm back. 39 years old, playing as if he was 29, but tough to overcome a bad shoulder.
Just got caught in an awkward position trying to bring down Brown. Woodson in his 18th year in the NFL. He has been an emotional leader for this Raider squad, blending the young players and the veterans. Third and four for Pittsburgh. Taylor Mays steps in to replace Woodson, and they're down a safety. T.J. Carey is out today with shoulder problems and a hip injury. Roethlisberger, nice setup for Williams. D'Angelo Williams on a catch and run. Out of bounds. Big gainer. Le'Veon Bell, who is known for his receiving skills, such a weapon in the passing game. Williams also a sure-handed receiver for Pittsburgh.
Well, you wonder with the injury to Woodson, this is a total blown coverage by the Raiders. Nobody picks up Williams out of the backfield, and he's good for 33 yards past midfield all the way to the Raider 40. But that shows you the problem when you have an all-pro player like Woodson going out on the second play of the game. Miscommunication in the secondary.
Williams goes in motion. New set of downs for Pittsburgh to work with at the 40 of Oakland. We're just underway. Roethlisberger, protection holds up, floats one, incomplete, off the hands of Heath Miller.
Really a nice toss by Roethlisberger. Curtis Lofton had his back to the quarterback. He puts it up high, and Miller normally will make that catch. So two drop passes on this drive as Charles Woodson checks back into the lineup.
Rebound!
Still not looking good, though. His right arm just dangling by his side.
Woodson had an interception last week in the win over the Jets. He's got five on the season, leading the NFL. Williams finds a running lane and takes it inside the 35. Defensively for the Oakland Raiders, Mario Edwards Jr. really caught the attention of Mike Tomlin in preparation for this game, raved about what he saw on tape. Linebackers, Malcolm Smith, versatile. He has really fit in nicely, came over from Seattle. And in the secondary, Larry Asante getting the start for the injured T.J. Carey today. It's a third and four now for the Steelers. Oakland has been the second best team in the NFL stopping the run. Out of the pistol, fake the toss. Roethlisberger looks downfield and makes the connection. The ball pops loose. Darius Hayward Bay, the former Raider, could not secure it, and now Pittsburgh is in no man's land. They would be looking at a 52-yard field goal, but it doesn't appear that the kicker, Chris Boswell, is coming on the field.
Yeah, after the fake to Williams on the toss, Williams again comes out of the backfield. Watch Williams here after the fake. Nobody's going to pick him up. He would have walked into the end zone here.
So the Steelers going for it on a fourth and four. Williams in the backfield, shotgun, Roethlisberger fires, incomplete. Brown got the step. David Amerson over there defensively, and the Raiders turn the Steelers over on downs. The little tip at the end by Amerson to make the play for Oakland. Raiders quarterback Derek Carr has been sensational the last 2 weeks, playing mistake-free football. Seven touchdowns, no interceptions in back-to-back wins over San Diego and the Jets. Raiders take over after the Steelers were unable to convert on fourth down. Line of scrimmage is the 34. First play on offense, ricochets, incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended receiver. Ross Cockrell was in as a nickel, and Mike Mitchell was in the vicinity.
Well, we've seen a bunch of drops today. This is just a great defensive play by Cockrell. Got his left hand in there. No separation at all on that route by Cooper. Cockrell read it perfectly and defended it even better.
Steelers electing not to try a 52-yard field goal. Tomlin going for it on fourth down. They decided not to try a 53-yard field goal last week. And a Murray! Latavius Murray breaking to the open field, and Murray down the sideline. Big back chased down by Antoine Blake. Murray is 6'3", 230 pounds. He's got the size, the speed, and apparently he's got the vision.
Well, here it is right here. Good blocking by Jamarcus Webb and Rodney Hudson, and he just squeezes through that hole. And now with this long stride and good speed, takes the ball all the way to the 22-yard line. Look at the vision right there. You talked about it, Bird.
Major upside in this sixth-round draft pick from 2013 out of Central Florida. First down for the Raiders. Carr unleashes to the end zone. It's caught! Michael Crabtree going upstairs for the touchdown. Crabtree, tremendous body control to put the Raiders in front.
As fourth touchdown reception of the season, as the Raiders go three plays and they're in the end zone after stopping the Steelers on fourth down. Look at the protection. Perfect. Ball thrown high between two defenders. And Crabtree's going to come down with it. You can see Carr is exactly where he wanted to go throughout the entire route. Putting the ball up high like that makes it so tough for the defenders to stop that type of pass.
Dan, that's three plays, 66 yards in 43 seconds.
They've been so good starting games the last 2 weeks.
In the first half, the last two games, they've outscored their opponents 51-12. Janikowski on for the extra point. And he knocks it through to put the Raiders in front, 7-0. Derek Carr. He is maturing before our eyes quickly. the quick strike capability of the Oakland Raiders. Crabtree, the 22-yard touchdown reception from Derek Carr. And the Raiders in front 7-0 against the Steelers.
And a unifying drive there. The defense does their job stopping the Steelers on fourth down, and then lightning strikes. Three plays, 66 yards and a score.
Kickoff from Janikowski. Jones was with San Diego, was let go, and Jones trying to resuscitate his return career comes up short of the 20-yard line.
Go back to the touchdown, and you can see it's a double route here. Here is Seth Roberts. He's got a clearing route here to hold the safety, and then watch the triple move by Crabtree as he goes to the post, back to the corner, back to the post. Ball delivered perfectly between the defensive backs. 16 touchdown passes now for number four.
So first and 10 for Pittsburgh. Charles Woodson is in for the Oakland Raiders. Take the handoff to Williams. Roethlisberger on a roll. Wide open. Keith Miller takes it to the 40-yard line and a 22-yard hookup as we check in with Evan Washburn. Evan?
We guys saw Charles Woodson bring down Heath Miller. He spent that entire series working on that right shoulder in obvious discomfort. Remember, week one, severely injured that right shoulder. We were told yesterday there were games up to this point where they thought Woodson would be able to play. He's going to fight through it. We'll just have to keep an eye on it, guys.
Jack Del Rio said yes. Woodson is blessed with an incredible amount of talent, but his work ethic is unparalleled. Williams looking for a hole, nothing there. Falls forward just across the 40-yard line. And the thing with Woodson, to be playing at this level at the age of 39, Del Rio said he brings youthful energy. He has so much pride. He sets an incredible example for the younger guys, and he's very vocal as a leader as well.
Well, you can see these other guys, a couple of quarterbacks, three of them, but Woodson plays that physical position where he's got to make tackles as he did on Heath Miller just then.
Heisman Trophy winner in 1997. D'Angelo Williams gets to the edge. Zigzags out of bounds. He made Mario Edwards Jr. miss and turns it into a 7-yard pickup for Mike Tomlin's team.
Yeah, that was interesting in talking to D'Angelo this week about, you know, how the press and the fans are concerned about him having to play to start a game. He says he finds it irritatingly exciting. It's an irritation because he has played 9 years in the league, but exciting that he knows the passion of these Steeler fans. They care nothing about the Carolina Panthers, all about Steeler Nation.
9 years as a member of the Panthers, Pro Bowl in 2009, 1,515 yards rushing in 08. Roethlisberger, deep shot, separation, but Brown couldn't catch up to it. Stride for stride, DJ Hayden with Larry Asante helping out for Oakland.
Yeah, Brown burning down the sidelines. He had enough separation. If he can catch this ball, he walks into the end zone. Working against DJ Hayden, you can see he's got a beat right there, but the ball about 3 yards too far from Roethlisberger.
Marcus Thigpen, new return man for the Oakland Raiders. He is back there waiting for the punt from Berry. Line drive, and this one is going to roll and die inside the five. Excellent job, special teams, as Hayward Bay gets down the field. 51-yard punt. Raiders are pinned deep. Oakland, they picked up large chunks of yards on their first drive and made it look easy. They've got a 7-0 lead on the road in Pittsburgh, the NFL on CBS. Your weekend starts with an AFC East showdown. Rex Ryan and the Bills visit the New York Jets. Thursday Night Football on NFL Network. Raiders take over with a first and 10 at its own 2-yard line. Working out of the shotgun. Carr rolling. Carr looking downfield, and he will throw it out of bounds. NFL Today had a feature on the weapons that Oakland has on offense, and they have been on full display the last 2 weeks. After the bye, it's been an Oakland explosion.
And they exploded that first drive. 44-yard run by Latavius Murray. And then the very next play, the 22-yard touchdown pass to Crabtree.
That 44-yard run, the longest run that Pittsburgh has given up this season. Second and 10 now for Oakland, five receivers set. Carr gets rid of it quickly. Tywan Jones breaks one tackle, then gets hit along the sideline. The ball popped loose. And was knocked out of bounds. Looked like Jones was down. Ryan Shazier over there, 6-yard pickup for Jones. Jones had a 59-yard touchdown reception last week against the Jets.
That's real close to being a fumble as the ball was moving, then kicked out of bounds. But the field judge, John Jenkins, came in right away to say he was down by contact.
It's a third and four for Oakland. Big play early defensively for Pittsburgh to keep the Raiders deep in their own territory. Ball pops loose. Oakland would have had enough on the pass. Clive Walford, the intended receiver, and it's fourth down.
Yeah, another drop pass here. This is a good ball by Carr. It looked like he was turning to get up the field. He should know, but as a rookie, you know, Walford just in his first year, seven catches on the season. Got to realize he had the first down with a catch. Didn't need extra yardage.
Jacoby Jones is the return man for Marquette King's punt. Jones has four punt returns for touchdowns in his career. Oh, that snap was offline. King handles it. High punt. Jones under it from the 44. Tries to make a move. Circles. And he's buried, loses yardage on the play, back at the 40-yard line. 48-yard punt and a loss of three on the return. Tywan Jones down the field to make the play. Line of scrimmage will be the 41-yard line.
Now the snap is by John Kondo, who's normally a real good snapper. Just King had trouble handling it. He reaches to his left, lucky to get that one off.
Two tight ends for Pittsburgh. They're playing without Matt Spaeth, who's out with a knee injury. So Jesse James will see extended action. Roethlisberger, tip ball, and it still got over to James. Jesse James down at the 50. 9-yard pickup. He's an outlaw.
Just a couple of little fingers on that, and the ball goes end over end to James to make the catch. Rams thought it was Heath Miller, didn't they?
For a moment.
Yep.
They got faked out.
Yep.
Chris Hubbard is on as an extra offensive lineman, so that's six for Pittsburgh. Miller the motion man on a second and one. Running play, Williams drives to the 49. It is enough. Justin Ellis gets credit for the stop. They'll move the chains for the Steelers.
That's a nice job of Williams cutting back over the middle to pick up that first down, something the Steelers need to get something going here. You can see they had a good drive to start the game like they did last week against Cincinnati, but couldn't pay it off.
It's the second game of a rare three-game homestand in the NFL. Last year, similar scenario. They went 3-0. Roethlisberger to the sideline. Raiders believe that Brown was out of bounds. The officials disagree. Clean catch for Brown, working against DJ Hayden, 13 yards.
I think the officials may have disagreed on this as well, but let's take a look at it.
Wow.
Oh, that's as close as you possibly can be. Watch the left foot. Right foot definitely in. Not so sure about the left foot.
Steelers get to the line quickly. Roethlisberger, though, taking his time on the count. First down, Roethlisberger fires it into Antonio Brown. And the Steelers building a rhythm here in the passing game, working against DJ Hayden, the third-year corner from Houston. That's an 8-yard pickup through the air.
You know, the Raiders could have challenged that because of the time that Roethlisberger took at the line of scrimmage. That was worth a challenge.
Ben Roethlisberger has passed Johnny Unitas for 15th all-time on the passing yardage list in NFL history. Roethlisberger. And this time the fans were right. It is Heath Miller for five. Hit by Curtis Lofton, middle linebacker for Oakland.
Yeah, the offensive line of the Steelers doing a real good job protecting Big Ben. Raiders come in with just 14 sacks on the season. Perfect 4-for-4 on this drive. You can see how quickly he gets rid of that ball. Heath Miller there in a crowd. What's new for Heath Miller, making a catch in the crowd.
So Roethlisberger, 96 yards overall.
Blue 20.
We still have 6:15 to play in this first quarter. Running play. D'Angelo Williams with a cut. Williams leans forward across the 15. Strong running by Williams. Excellent block up front by Ramon Foster for Pittsburgh. That's a 9-yard gain.
And he looks like a slalom skier through this one. He follows his fullback Roosevelt Nix and sees the hole. Cuts right, cuts left, back to the right. 9 yards.
Second and one coming up. See if Dan will have another Winter Olympics reference at some point in this game. Luge?
Perhaps. Timeout.
Play clock winding down. Steelers will use a timeout. Tomorrow on CBS, why be ordinary when it's your destiny to be super? Don't miss a new episode of the hit drama, Supergirl. That's tomorrow at 8, 7 Central, only CBS.
Might have been a personnel issue for the Steelers having to use that timeout here.
David DeCastro came out, so they might be working on DeCastro.
Apparently it was an equipment malfunction. Shoe came off. Not the malfunction you normally might see in this situation.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for confirming.
It was there somewhere.
DeCastro will be in there. And the line of scrimmage is now the 13-yard line on a second and one for Pittsburgh, yeah, looking for the equalizer. They trail the Raiders 7-0.
Three down, 27.
Steelers are averaging 6 points less per game compared to last year in 62 yards less. Remember, Roethlisberger missed 4 games. Give it to Williams. They need a yard. He's going to lose yardage. He's brought down short of the 15. Khalil Mack hemmed him in. It's a loss of 2 on the play.
Talking to Ken Norton Jr. about Mack, he says he loves his attitude. He's serious about the game of football. Tough, coachable, durable, and he's better than against the run than you might think. He leads the Raiders in tackles for losses, as he did that time.
And he prefers his name to be pronounced Khalil, and I'm really not going to question it.
No, me neither. I'm going to just call him Mack.
Third and 4. Roethlisberger. Timing was off. Trying to hit Wheaton, and now it's fourth down. Steelers will have to settle for a field goal attempt, and this promising drive comes to a halt.
Well, you can see Wheaton is cutting to the inside, ball thrown to the outside, and away from the defender.
Things out of sync on that pass play. This will be a 34-yard attempt for Chris Boswell in his first year from Rice. He has been perfect so far. And that streak continues. 9 of 9 on the season. The Steelers are on the board as he knocks it through from 34 yards away. It's 7-3, Raiders. Packed house at Heinz Field, a 9-play, 43-yard drive. Took just over 4 minutes. Boswell, the 34-yard field goal. And the Raiders lead Pittsburgh 7-3. Boswell will kick it off. Tywan Jones is the deep man for Oakland. Jones averaging 28 yards per return. Matt Jones stood up as he hit the 35-yard line by Shamarco Thomas on special teams. All right, this is where things stand in the AFC. Teams that are 500 or better, that's it. Cincinnati, New England, Denver undefeated. So you have the haves, there are a lot of have-nots, and then three teams hovering with Oakland, the Jets, and Pittsburgh in that next category.
And then you have the AFC South, which is really south this year. They don't even have a team above 500. 10 teams struggling halfway through the season.
Raiders have it first and 10 at their own 25.
Down! We're waiting! What's up?
Motion man Holmes on the rollout car downfield. open, and Roberts could not hold on to it. Is that a clean catch for Roberts and just nobody was there? No, it's incomplete. Seth Roberts, first year out of West Alabama, has 9 catches on the season. This should have been number 10.
Yeah, he was wide open on the crossing route. Good rollout throw on the run by Carr. And as he goes to the ground, ball comes out. That's a good job of the officials getting together and figuring that one out and calling that incomplete.
So it's 2nd and 10 now for Oakland. They will go with 6 offensive linemen. Khalif Barnes, the veteran, now in his 11th year. In the backfield, Murray. A cut by Murray. He's hit from behind and picks up 3 yards on the play. Latavius Murray said the last few weeks they've been most effective going to the outside. That loosens things up and then opens up some areas inside the tackles.
And it makes you think about the Steelers. They know that as well. So where did the Raiders gash the Steelers with the first carry today? Was right up the middle by Murray.
Latavius Murray grew up a big Fred Taylor fan, who Jack Del Rio coached in Jacksonville. He said Taylor was a physical runner, nothing flashy, just liked his style. Carr, on time, makes the connection with Michael Rivera, the tight end. That's 8 yards, and they'll move the chains for Oakland.
And not a lot of catches by the Raider tight ends. That's the 12th for Rivera this season. Lee Smith has 7, and Clive Walford has 7. So Walford dropped a pass earlier. That one, good throw by Carr for the first down.
We come up on 3 minutes to play in this opening quarter. Raiders are on the move, a 1st and 10 at the 36. Shotgun again for Carr. Hand it off, Murray. No room to work with for Murray. He's brought down by Stephon Tuitt, who's back in the lineup for Pittsburgh. NFL Today update, JB and Boomer.
A hot breeze. And modern day Dan Fouts, if you will. How about Drew Brees, 38 yards to his go-to guy, Brandon Cooks. Drew Brees, 8 of 10, 150 yards, 2 touchdowns against the Titans in the first quarter, 14-3 Saints.
Fouts is associated with high scoring, right?
Yes, he is. Yes.
I am, Dan, and Evan.
Yeah, the Saints have it rolling right now after that win over Atlanta. That's really triggered their season. Marshall Reese gets the carry, and Reese going airborne. He's hit. Out across the 45, it's a 12-yard pickup. He took a shot from Mike Mitchell, enough for a first down.
Yeah, good job by Reese to read the defense here. Gets a good kickout block that time from his tight end, Lee Smith.
Mitchell tried to knock the ball free with his helmet. Just the 3rd carry of the season for Reese. 3-time Pro Bowler, multi-dimensional at that fullback spot. Carr out of the pocket. Carr downfield. Oh, what a grab by Crabtree, but he was out of bounds. They talk about his hands. Rob Moore, the wide receiver coach, has been blown away by Crabtree's hands and his ability to suck in these balls.
Really extends nicely, but the ball carries him out of bounds. Left foot in, right foot way out of bounds.
Crabtree is putting up career numbers this season. His first year with the Raiders, first 6 years in the NFL with San Francisco. 2nd and 10. Out near midfield, we are under 2 minutes to play in the opening quarter. Motion man Jones. Carr downfield. In a crowd, it's knocked away. Tried to squeeze it into Lee Smith. Snuffed out by Timmons for Pittsburgh. Never miss a moment of football action with the CBS Sports app. Every play and score, every game, and every highlight right as they happen. Download the CBS Sports app now at cbssports.com/mobile. Carr is now 3 of 9, 36 yards, and the touchdown pass to Crabtree. They are yet to get Amari Cooper involved. 8th play of the drive. It's 3rd and 10 for the Raiders. Deep drop. Carr, sideline throw. Again, Crabtree's got it, but he was not in bounds. 4th down for Oakland. Coverage from Antoine Blake.
Yeah, great coverage by Antoine Blake. He is right in the back pocket of Crabtree. Again, the left foot is in, the right foot is out. Risky throw by Carr. Blake had that huge interception last week against Cincinnati in the end zone. If he could have located that ball, he might have picked that one off.
Marquette King will punt it, averaging 45 and a half yards per kick with Jacoby Jones waiting for it at the Pittsburgh 10. Kondo, the snapper. King leans into it. Returnable for Jones from the 12. Jones trying to go upfield. He's buried at the 17-yard line. A 40-yard punt. 5-yard return. Roethlisberger and the Steelers get it back. They trail Oakland 7-3. First quarter.
Jacoby Jones was claimed off waivers from San Diego. On Friday, he came to Pittsburgh. And to me, it looks like this return should come this way, because he has all these blockers setting up the picket line. Even one of the blockers calling for him to go to the left side.
So the Steelers open up at their own 17 with a play action. Roethlisberger looking for the home run ball. Deep is Brown. Antonio Brown with the grab. Stays on his feet. Brought down inside the 25. 59 yards on the hookup.
That equals his longest catch of the season. And Roethlisberger, after the play fake, is going to throw it about as far as he possibly can. Little pump fake there. Look at Brown with his head down running, locates the ball behind Woodson, shakes off Woodson. DJ Hayden has to prevent the touchdown.
Antonio Brown is on pace for 104 catches and nearly 1,500 yards this season. Williams picks up 3 yards on the play. And a little extracurricular activity afterwards. Justin Ellis wrapping up Williams. Marcus Gilbert had something to say.
The one thing this Pittsburgh offensive line really appreciates about D'Angelo Williams is that, being the veteran that he is, he always seeks to seek out the proper hole. As you see the numbers, the awesome numbers for Antonio Brown.
Remember, Brown was playing with Michael Vick, not Roethlisberger, for a stretch, and his numbers suffered. Marcus Wheaton is thrown down. DJ Hayden with the tackle. It's a loss of 2 on the play, and that will do it for the first quarter. Raiders leading the Steelers 7-3. Pittsburgh, though, is threatening. We'll come back to Heinz Field after these messages. You're watching the NFL on CBS, home of Super Bowl 50. Steelers come in ranked 20th in total offense, 349 yards per game. They put up 177 in that first quarter, but only 3 points to show for it.
Hey, four down!
Trying to add to that total here, facing a third and 9, first play of the second quarter in Pittsburgh. D'Angelo Williams sets up off to the side of Roethlisberger on a third and 9. Out of the gun. Roethlisberger steps up, throws to Antonio Brown, breaks a tackle, and Brown is out of bounds. First down, Steelers on the catch and run. Amerson could not bring him down. It's 13 yards for Brown.
A classic stiff arm here on Amerson. Left hand right to the jaw of Amerson. First down, Steelers.
Amerson picked up off of waivers from Washington.
You know, you can, as an offensive player, put your hand in the face mask of the defender. You just can't grab it.
It's a first and 10 from the 12. 5 receiver set. Quick hitter underneath. Antonio Brown inside the 5. DJ Hayden with a tackle.
That's 6 catches now for Antonio Brown. Just a quick hitter here, but he lowers his head here and gets close to the first down. Good effort by Brown, just 180 pounds as he hits Woodson. Woodson playing again with that bad shoulder. It's almost as if the Steelers know about that and sense it.
Second and 1 for Pittsburgh. Give it to Williams. Williams got the running lane, and he's got the touchdown for Pittsburgh. D'Angelo Williams takes it in, and he puts the Steelers in front.
Again, it's just Just great vision by Williams. Watch as he looks here and then comes back over here to get into the end zone. Great cutback all the way behind his right tackle, Marcus Gilbert.
50th career touchdown for the veteran D'Angelo Williams. And the Steelers are going for two, leading it 9-7.
Well, they've been 3 of 5 converting on second on two-point conversions.
Roethlisberger connects with Williams and put two on the board for Pittsburgh. It's 11-7 Steelers.
Yeah, we're open all night too, huh?
Oh, you're reading the scoreboard that way, are you? Maybe a Slurpee for you, Dan?
That would be nice.
Williams, the spin and in. Roethlisberger converts. Todd Haley, offensive coordinator for the Steelers. With the change in the extra point in the NFL, everybody was curious, how would teams handle it? Most of the teams just go with the standard point after. Pittsburgh has taken a different tact this season.
They've gone for it 6 times now and made it 4. Brown, Miller, Wheaton, and now Williams have got 2 pointers on the season. But if you have a quarterback like Roethlisberger, you trust him to get to the ball to the proper receiver. 4 for 4 on this drive, including this 59-yarder to Antonio Brown. In fact, it was Brown's drive, 3 catches on the drive. Great stiff arm there, then the quick slant route, lowers his head and gets down to the 3-yard line. And from there, D'Angelo Williams walks into the end zone.
On that drive, big numbers in the first half. Big numbers, 6 catches, 106 yards. Steelers have put 200 yards up in the first half. Hand off to Murray. Latavius Murray takes a shot. Mike Mitchell throwing his body around. Murray pops up. It's a 9-yard pickup for Murray.
Well, Murray, 6'3", runs high. He is tall, and he's going to take a shot right in the chest here that straightens him up. He does pack 225 pounds into that body. Remind some people of the great Hall of Famer Marcus Allen.
Eddie George, Eric Dickerson, those are other comparisons he's heard through the years because of that taller stature. He said he's watched film on all of these guys trying to pick up things from the taller running backs. Murray, tough to bring down. It's a 3-yard gain. They needed just a yard, and it's good enough for a first down. Will Allen returning for Pittsburgh. Allen had missed the previous 3 games. Allen was out with a left ankle injury.
And the thing Murray appreciates about this offensive line is how athletic they are and how well they run. They get out in front, and they have the size and power to open up holes right up the middle.
20, go 20.
It's a 4-receiver set.
20.
And it's Carr out of the gun. Motion man is Jones, shifting to the other side. Take the handoff, Carr. He's got Crabtree. Michael Crabtree on the curl into Pittsburgh territory. First down for the Raiders. 20 yards.
Yeah, and in talking to Derek Carr last night, he was excited about their chances because the Steelers play so much off coverage. They're unique in that they don't press, bump, and run very often. And that allows the receivers free access to the secondary, as we saw that time in the 20-yard gain by Crabtree.
And this is a different offense than the one Derek Carr ran last season. Bill Musgrave in his first year as the offensive coordinator for the Raiders. Jack Del Rio, of course, revamped the coaching staff when we got the head coaching job. Carr flicks it. A juggle and a catch. Cooper lost the ball at the end of the play. And it's going to be ruled incomplete.
The ball is well thrown by Carr, but Cooper not able to haul it in. Then it was knocked out. Raiders have had 3 drops here in the first half.
Bill Musgrave, second stint with Oakland. He was actually the quarterback coach back in 1997. Spent 2 years as the offensive coordinator under Del Rio in Jacksonville. 17th drop pass of the season for the Raiders. Murray pushed from behind by Gabe Jackson, and that got him some extra yards. 4.5 for Murray. And again, words exchanged as the officials come between these two teams, and the big guys, offensive linemen and defensive linemen, disagreeing. Jamarcus Webb jawing with Cameron Hayward. And Hayward's a new dad. Congratulations to Cameron Hayward and his wife, Allie. They welcomed the baby boy yesterday morning, Callum, to the world. Yeah, it's a 3rd and 5 for Oakland. Out of the gun, Carr. Nobody home. It's incomplete. Amari Cooper in the general area for Oakland. It's 4th down.
Yeah, been a bad first half for Amari Cooper. That ball thrown behind him. You wonder about this type of pass. You can see what Carr is seeing. He sees the safety coming over from the inside. Will Allen, so he throws it to the off shoulder, and Cooper did not make the adjustment. Carr now just 4 of 13 for 56 yards.
Marquette King will punt it. Jacoby Jones waiting for it at the Pittsburgh 9-yard line. Third punt for King. High punt, end over end. Jones will let it bounce. The Raiders get down the field, and Pittsburgh is going to be deep in its own territory. Corey Toomer on special teams. Well-placed punt by King of 41 yards. 11-7 Pittsburgh. Absolutely beautiful day in Pittsburgh. Do we just travel these?
Well, the bird and the beard are everywhere, especially in Pittsburgh.
I'd like to experience some of what the bird and the beard jerseys get to experience week in and week out. They go to great places.
A boat trip there? Awesome.
On first down, D'Angelo Williams rumbles for a couple. It's a 2-yard pickup. Ben Roethlisberger, the concern wearing that left knee brace was about the mobility. And we asked him about it. He said, look, it didn't feel like the old me last week, but I felt okay out there. It's getting better every day. It's a different experience, but once you're out there, you don't think about
it.
Well, the protection he's getting today, he hasn't had to really test that knee or that brace. He's got great pass protection, has not had to extend one play yet out of the pocket.
It's a 2nd and 8 for the Steelers. Low throw, Brown.
Bounced.
It did. Incomplete.
And Roethlisberger rushed this throw. One hopped it to Antonio Brown. Sorry, dude.
Who said sorry, Ben?
You bet he did.
So earlier, the Pittsburgh defense stopped Oakland deep in its own territory. Now it's Oakland that's trying to do the same against Pittsburgh. 3rd and 8. Did you say sorry a lot to your receivers, Dan?
And when I one hopped him, you bet. I didn't want them to feel like I was avoiding them. Just a crummy throw.
Here's Roethlisberger. Incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended target. Amerson drawing the assignment. And the Steelers go 3 and out.
Good coverage by Amerson. Some of the fans thought he might have arrived a little early here. He's got that left arm wrapped around Antonio Brown and turns him just a bit, swipes the ball with his right hand, and does not draw a flag.
Big opportunity here for Marcus Thigpen, the newest Raider, with Jordan Berry punting out of his own end zone. End over end. This ball never made it to Thigpen, and it takes an Oakland bounce. Raiders are going to have opening field position at the Pittsburgh 40 after the 36-yard punt. Steelers holding on to an 11-7 lead on Oakland. Second quarter action continues. The NFL is honoring the military in its Salute to Service games this week, which includes Pittsburgh offensive lineman Alejandro Villanueva. Villanueva, West Point graduate, 3 tours in Afghanistan as a platoon leader with the Army Rangers. In honor of Veterans Day, for every point scored during the NFL's 32 Salute to Service games, the league will donate $1,000 to its nonprofit partners, the Pat Tillman Foundation, USO, and Wounded Warrior Project, To join the salute and learn more, visit NFL.com/salute. First and 10 for Oakland at the Pittsburgh 40. Running play, Murray slowed down, and Murray kept his balance to pick up a few. Give him 3 yards. Cameron Hayward cut him down low. That affected the Murray run. Now for the Raiders, when Murray gets it going, it leads to victories. Murray, it was basically an audition last year when he stepped in late in the season, and the Raiders liked what they saw. They ended up signing Roy Helu in the offseason. But Murray clearly won this job. Murray carries again, just short of the 30-yard line. Good block by Donald Penn up front, the former Buccaneer.
And because his first carry went for 44 yards, he already has 73 yards here in the first half.
Last week had 113 yards in the win over the Jets with a 5.7 per carry average, third career 100-yard game.
Last one. Down.
It's a third and one for Oakland. Murray feed him the football. And Murray's forward progress will get him the first down. Inside the 30 with a pickup of 3, hit by Lawrence Timmons. Antoine Blake tried to bring him down initially. So new set of downs for Oakland to work with 8:28 and counting left in this first half.
That was a nice job by Murray, getting all the way back to his two tight ends on the strong side of the formation and then just turning his body slightly to pick up the first down.
Jack Del Rio has brought a new attitude to this team. Latavius Murray said you could feel it even in OTAs. The atmosphere was different. So Murray said, I'm not surprised that the team has been this successful. Tywan Jones gets the carry and driven down. Hayward, first man there. Harrison helping out as well. It's a loss of one. It's been a long time in Oakland. Last winning season was 2002 for the Raiders. That's the longest active drought in the NFL.
Now, Del Rio wanted to paint a picture of positive outcomes, and everyone bought in early because of his track record. They're developing more confidence each week, obviously.
Four straight runs for the Raiders. This is a second and 11 now for Oakland. It's a running play to Jones. Oh, the ball pops loose. That's fortunate for the Raiders that it came to the sideline. Will Allen with the stamp.
Yeah, along with Antoine Blake here, Blake's going to put his helmet right on the ball, his shoulder rather, and a fortunate bounce for the Raiders as it trickles out of bounds.
Jones heads to the Oakland sideline. It's third and 10 now for the Raiders.
Now four.
We hit 7 minutes to play in the second quarter. 11-7, Pittsburgh in front. Operating out of the gun, deep drop. Carr fires over the middle. It's complete. Makes the connection to Cooper for a first down.
Well, Carr did a good job of reading the blitz, knowing he's got single coverage on the outside. As Amari Cooper cuts to the inside, Blake expecting help from his safety, Mike Mitchell, that time that never came. It's a third down conversion. Good for 13 yards. First catch of the afternoon after struggling earlier.
Cooper has more catches, more yards, and more touchdowns than all the other first-round wide receivers combined. He's on pace for 1,291 yards in his rookie season. First and 10 from the 15. Carr throws. End zone. Amari Cooper, touchdown Raiders. Derek Carr lofts it to Cooper. A breakdown defensively for Pittsburgh.
Well, I thought he was open on the third down play. This is really open. Time to throw. Carr looks off the safety. And there's just nobody there. See, Roberts cut to the inside. Cooper realizing there's nobody back there. And that's a tougher catch than you might think because you know it's going to be good for six.
It's an AC-DC connection for Oakland. Amari Cooper's the AC, Carr's the DC.
I get it. That's good. Electrifying.
And they're back in silver and black. Seven plays, 40 yards. Remember the field position that they started with. The Raiders take full advantage of it. Oakland in Pittsburgh. They've got a 14-11 lead on the Steelers. Another strong first half for the Oakland Raiders. Did it a couple of weeks ago against San Diego, again last week against the Jets. That drive took 3 minutes and 47 seconds. Cooper, the 15-yard touchdown reception for Oakland. Jacoby Jones, the return man, will take it out. 1 yard deep in the end zone. Jones trying to get to the outside, and he's brought down at the 22. You know about this rivalry? Well, this guy knows a whole lot about it. Evan Washburn standing by with a special guest.
I think so. And Franco Harris joins me. And this rivalry's got some juice again. What does it mean to see this game have some meaning like it did back in your day?
You know what? There's a lot of energy today. You feel the excitement. The rivalry has, for years, has been ready to explode. And they were just ready, you know, ready for the teams to show up and play the type of football that we used to play. And we're getting that game today. It's so exciting. There are a number of Raider fans here too, so maybe it makes it more exciting. So this is Steeler and Raider football right here.
Well, it's impossible to have this game and not talk about the play, the immaculate reception. I guess I'm most curious, how often do you think about that play?
People remind me about it just about every day. And you know what? It's a big part of our legacy. It's a big part of the 70s. And it's something that will always connect us with the Raiders in any way that, you know, how people want to accept it. But it's great when you have a play like that and with two teams that have this great history. So it's all great.
We really appreciate it, Franco. Thank you.
My pleasure.
All right, guys, thanks very much. Antonio Brown on the running play to the outside, 16 yards. Franco Harris still has to hear from Raider Nation behind him. The one guy had a leather lung.
Yeah, Charles Woodson is down. He made the tackle, saved the touchdown. But Woodson, again, suffering from that bad right shoulder.
Yeah, he's playing hurt right now. They're dealing with Woodson on the sideline. Charles Woodson is doing everything he can to stay on the field and protect that right shoulder. But that shot that he actually dished out just to get Brown to the sideline is the reason why Woodson is now being worked on.
Yeah, they're fitting him for a shoulder brace. You can see the hit with the right shoulder, and then he lands on the right shoulder.
39-year-old Charles Woodson, 8-time Pro Bowler. Taylor Mays has stepped in to replace him. The Steelers in business at the 43-yard line with a first and 10. Roethlisberger to throw it. It's knocked away, and it's Mays who makes the play on Miller. Let's check in with Evan Washburn. Evan?
Well, guys, just to add to that, it's a neoprene harness that he kind of puts that right shoulder into, and they're adjusting all of his equipment. Now, as we mentioned, this is an injury that he sustained early in the season, week one, that he's had to manage throughout the season. So this, as I've been told, is something they've dealt with on a week-to-week basis. We'll continue to monitor it if it affects his availability.
Yeah, there were a couple of times in this season where Jack Del Rio thought, well, there's no way he's going to play this week. There's just no way. And there he is making plays on Sundays. D'Angelo Williams, 3-yard pickup just to create that kind of yardage. Took some effort. Alden Smith in on the stop for Oakland.
And what the Raiders have done defensively with Woodson out is they've shifted Larry Asante into his position, and Taylor Mays has taken over Asante's position. So you'll see Asante playing the deep center field that we're so used to seeing number 24. Charles Woodson take.
Asante, formerly with Tampa Bay and Indianapolis, played in 6 games last season. Former fifth-round draft pick of the Browns in 2010. 3rd and 7 now for Pittsburgh. From the gun, Roethlisberger. It's a deep ball over the shoulder. Antonio Brown. Roethlisberger drops it in the bucket. He took a shot from Alden Smith. 41 yards.
Tremendous adjustment to the ball. Thrown over his outside shoulder. There's a shot from Alden Smith. Look at how he tracks that ball down and makes the catch. 8 catches in the first half for 152 yards for Antonio Brown. And the quarterback is driven to the ground by number 99.
Career high for him in a first half. First and 10 from the 12. Running play. Williams. Williams cuts through. Brought down inside the 5. Alejandro Villanueva with a key block up front. 8.5 yards on the game for Williams, who's done a nice job on the ground for Pittsburgh.
But watch the patience. He waits and waits and waits, a little bit like Le'Veon Bell does, and then finds the hole, lets the blockers do their job. In behind Villanueva.
Second and 2. Williams again brought down low. Malcolm Smith helped save a touchdown.
There's no question about it. Malcolm Smith, as it looked like Williams was ready to step out of that arm tackle and step into the end zone, but Smith hanging on for dear life keeps him out.
We've got a stoppage here. The officials are huddling up. Might be a measurement, and it is.
Official timeout. Malcolm Smith, the Super Bowl MVP of Super Bowl 48, was recruited by Ken Norton Jr. when Norton was the assistant coach at USC.
And then Norton coached him in Seattle as they come up short of the first down. So it's no surprise that Malcolm Smith is now with Oakland, because Ken Norton Jr. is the defensive coordinator.
And when Smith became available through free agency, Norton says, we got to have him so he can help spread his message of how he wants his defense run.
Signed a 2-year, $7 million deal with the Oakland Raiders, a 7th-round pick in 2011. All right, so the Steelers are facing 3rd and a little less than a yard. They'll go with a 6th offensive lineman, Chris Hubbard, out of Alabama, Birmingham.
And their big fullback, Will Johnson, 6'2", 240 pounds, is in the huddle as well.
So they can still get a first down. The line of scrimmage is just shy of the 2.
Cody, no spacing.
It's 3rd down. Give it to Williams, who is stuffed.
Yeah, Smith got him again. This time he went high, got him by the shoulder, and dropped him short of the first down.
So what do you do?
I think you go for it. This is an attitude type of drive here. The bomb to Antonio Brown got him down here. But that penetration by Smith and company stopped the first down. Decision time now for Mike Tomlin.
They're going to measure again. They didn't gain anything.
Yeah, the first quarter they went for it on 4th down and actually ended up losing yardage. See what they need here, if anything.
Yeah, they're short. So they'll have the 2-minute warning to think about it. They'll get the clock going on 4th and less than a yard for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, you'd think with Ben Roethlisberger as your quarterback, a quarterback sneak would be in order. List him at 250 pounds, 6'5". Don't call him Big Ben for nothing, do they?
Is that rhetorical, or you wanted an answer on that one?
I'll get back to you after this.
Think about it during the 2-minute warning. Short field goal would tie it. Mike Tomlin has made his plan very clear. They're going for it on 4th and less than a yard.
He's brought in 3 wide receivers to spread the Raiders out. Roethlisberger in the shotgun, look for a pick down here at the bottom as they line up in tandem.
Motion man is Brown. Handoff. D'Angelo Williams runs it in for the touchdown. Number 2 for Williams, and the Steelers go back in front.
Yeah, really a great call by Todd Haley. Giving them the look of the pass play, running the draw, and Williams has his 2nd touchdown of the day. This type of motion got Brown a touchdown last week against Cincinnati. I wonder if his knee was down before he crossed the plane there. They'll take a look at it because it's a scoring play. His knee definitely was down before the ball was down.
Legs were churning, knee down there.
Yeah, he crossed the plane there. You can see the ball over the front part of the goal line. And this would be confirmed for a touchdown for Pittsburgh.
Steelers lost Le'Veon Bell for the season last week. MCL tear in his right knee. Every scoring play is reviewed, so they're just confirming it. D'Angelo Williams has stepped in. 14 carries, 45 yards, two touchdowns for Williams.
Good block by Villanueva there, as he takes care of Mario Edwards.
Mike Carey has been watching this back in New York, our rules expert. Mike, what'd you see on that play?
Well, there's two things to look for. Was the knee down? And it's really difficult to tell there. But even if it was, both angles show that the ball had already broken the plane. So in my opinion, this is a score.
All right, Mike. To see if Bill Vinovich agrees with your opinion. We haven't heard from Bill Vinovich because there have been no penalties. Zero.
Is this a Steeler Raider game?
It is.
No penalties?
This is not of your Steeler Raider era, Dan.
You know, this is an election year, and we need to have, you know, equal time. We had Franco Harris. We're going to get the call first from Bill Vinovich.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
Well, that's where Bill gets to hear a huge ovation from the crowd.
I'm surprised he didn't take a bow. But in talking to Bill Musgrave about his combination of Crabtree and Cooper, he says it's like having Biletnikoff and Branch all over again for the Raiders.
Extra point here for Chris Boswell. Are you voting this year for president then, or?
I am undecided.
I guess so.
I'll buffer on that one.
You got some time to think about it. Pittsburgh Steelers, strong drive, 18-14 they lead it. Second quarter. Coming up, Verizon Halftime Report. JB, Tony, Bart, Boomer, Coach Cower. Latest NFL scores and highlights. And a preview of Thursday night football only on the NFL Network. That's all coming up on the Verizon Halftime Report. So D'Angelo Williams stepping in, and Williams has delivered. I feel like for Williams, it's been a resurgence as well. Change of scenery. We asked him why Pittsburgh. He said, hey, I wanted to go to a team that was thinking about winning Super Bowls. That's their focus, not a rebuilding situation. Tylon Jones, the return man for Oakland. And Jones is spun down at the 22-yard line. So the Raiders will have it with a minute 49 left.
And the other thing about Williams is he knew he was going to play right away because of the suspension of Le'Veon Bell. So in his mind, he was taking up right where he left off in Carolina as a starting tailback.
Mike Tomlin said, Williams, great demeanor, competitor. He's been there, done that kind of guy. Good communicator with the young players and someone for them to look up to. So it's been a home run signing for the Pittsburgh Steelers, and the circumstances have put him into a prime time position. So the Raiders take over, first and 10 at their own 22. They have all three timeouts remaining. Crabtree the catch, and driven down by William Gay. Gay is playing in his 137th consecutive game now in his ninth year in the league.
Yeah, tremendous reaction by William Gay as he came up quickly. Crabtree had nowhere to go with this catch. And the Raiders waste a first down.
Hang on with me.
It's a loss of one on the play. Sidearm delivery. Catch made by Murray. It's whistled down as Cameron Hayward makes the stop. 3-yard pickup. And the clock is ticking, a minute eight left.
How about Hayward coming out of his three-point stance to play the crossing route of the tailback? The new daddy with a heck of a play.
And the son of the late Craig Ironhead Hayward, Cameron Hayward, has emerged as a true leader for this defense. 1:10 left. Pittsburgh has called the timeout. Steelers will have one timeout remaining. And the Raiders face a third and eight. 280 yards of offense for Pittsburgh. The Raiders have 174. They had 451 yards of offense against one of the top-ranked defenses in the NFL last week, the Jets.
And the Steelers have overcome their drop passes in that first quarter. Roethlisberger now 13 of 22 for 219. No picks.
50.
Big play on a third and eight. Four straight completions for Carr. They hand it off. Murray is carried behind the line of scrimmage by Blake. They red run. And it's a loss of four for Oakland.
Well, the key on this was Antoine Blake on the corner blitz. Watch 41 come in here. That's where Murray wanted to run that ball, and Blake is all over him. Creative blitz that time. Keith Butler, defensive coordinator. 23 sacks on the season now for the Steelers. That's the first sack of the year for Blake, so that means 11 different Steelers have taken down the quarterback behind the line of scrimmage.
Pittsburgh is out of timeouts with 107 to play. And Marquette King getting ready to punt it to the veteran Jacoby Jones. Jones, of course, had that 2013 incident when he collided with Mike Tomlin on the sideline, ended up costing Tomlin $100,000, a fine from the NFL for getting in the way of Jones on a return when he was with Baltimore. King the boot. This ball bounces at the 43 and rolls to the 41. King did not get all of that one. That's a 39-yard punt. And the Steelers have excellent field position with 59 seconds to work with. Coming up, Verizon Halftime Report. JB, Tony, Bart, Boomer, Coach Coward. Latest NFL scores and highlights. And a preview of Thursday Night Football only on the NFL Network. That's all coming up on the Verizon Halftime Report.
Charles Woodson back in the lineup for the Raiders. You can see how heavily braced he is on his right arm and shoulder.
And four down! 53!
Roethlisberger is 13 of 22, 219 yards. They would need 25 yards for a 52-yard field goal. Roethlisberger, sideline. Incomplete, flag down. Miller matched up with Mays. The first penalty marker of the afternoon.
Pass interference. Defense number 27. Spot foul. Automatic first down.
So move the chains. 11-yard penalty. And now the ball is in Oakland territory at the 48.
Yeah, they're going to keep going. They're going to try and get all the way down into the end zone here. They've had a lot of success throwing deep today, especially Antonio Brown.
Seven pass interference penalties against the Raiders this season, second in the NFL. Roethlisberger steps up, avoids the rush. Roethlisberger, he's got Brown downfield for a first down. Emerson lost Brown. 19 yards. Those two are just on the same page.
Well, watch Roethlisberger get away from Edwards, steps up in the pocket, and knows he's got Antonio Brown hiding out on the sideline in front of Emerson.
That is 171 yards receiving for Brown in the first half.
Cody, don't sit.
Line of scrimmage is the 29. 48 seconds to go. Williams in the backfield. Good block from Williams. Roethlisberger has the time. He'll throw. End zone. Incomplete. Diving attempt by Wheaton with DJ Hayden back there for Oakland.
Close. Real close. You can see the grab there by Hayden. He gets away with it. Well, just off the fingertips of Wheaton, but how about that pass protection? That got everybody in the stands excited.
And four down.
It was Alden Smith trying to get to the QB, and D'Angelo Williams helping out with a crushing block. Play clock is down to two. Out of the gun, Roethlisberger in trouble. Gets rid of it. It's poked away. Williams' intended receiver, Taylor Mays, slaps at the football, and it's third and 10 for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, and that attempt at a sack might have pushed the Steelers out of field goal range, but the strength of Roethlisberger to shake off the tackle and get rid of the ball to an eligible receiver may have saved the Steelers 3 points here. You can see Malcolm Smith just spinning around Big Ben.
Right now they're looking at a 47-yard attempt.
Remember, Tomlin turned down a 52-yard try in the first quarter.
Raiders have seven defensive backs in there on a third and 10. Once again out of the gun, Roethlisberger pulls the trigger and connects. Antonio Brown out to the 20-yard line.
And he's just short of the first down, too. Needed to get to the 19. Look at the timing here. Perfect timing as Brown coming back to the ball. That'll bring up a fourth down and decision time for Mike Tomlin.
33 seconds left.
And the play clock is running, so they have no time out to talk about it on the sideline.
They're going for it. They're not sending the field goal kicker out. It's a fourth and one. And it might be Oakland that takes the timeout to get organized.
The previous play is under review.
Yeah, this is a break for the Steelers.
Now this acts as a timeout for Pittsburgh.
No question. Tomlin should call Roethlisberger over to discuss this next play.
Under 2 minutes, it's an official review.
Yep.
The momentum carried Brown back the other way. And they're going to check and see where they spot the football. They needed to get to the 19-yard line.
Now, he had the ball in his left hand. If he holds it in his right hand, he may get the call here. But you can see where the ball is when he goes out of bounds. He's well short of the first down.
Now, you're right about that, Dan. The ball placement may have been the difference here in coming up short and forcing the Steelers into a decision.
And so many times you see players now with the awareness to hold the ball out, knowing what they need, but first things first, make the catch, and that's what was on Brown's mind.
Well, look, if they're short, it appears they're going for it on fourth down, at least with the personnel that's on the field right now. It might be fourth and half a yard when they take a look at that spot on review.
Well, last time they ran a draw play and it worked so well they got a touchdown out of it. They're one of two this afternoon, converting fourth downs.
Here's Bill Vinovich.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is confirmed. The runner was coming back on his own prior to contact. It'll be fourth and a half at the 19 and a half yard line.
Well, that's the life of an official. 1 minute, you're the most popular guy in the stadium. The next minute, they boo you.
Oh, they're cheering in the Bay Area, though.
And they are sending out the field goal unit now. Boswell will come out. Mike Tomlin waited to see what the call was and then made the decision to take the 3 points. This is a 38-yard attempt for Boswell. Was on the Houston practice squad.
Now, because of that two-point conversion, this would increase the lead to seven.
And he nails it. It was a strange way to get to 21, but they got there. It's 21-14 Pittsburgh. 29 seconds left, first half.
Now, you talked about Antonio Brown's huge first half. So let's take a look at it. 10 catches for 180 yards. Started with this 59-yard bomb in the first quarter. And then the stiff arm right there to get out of bounds. And then the little end-around play where he gained 16 yards. Another bomb. Great adjustment to the ball over the shoulder.
It's 14 targets for Brown. And that's a career high in any half for Antonio Brown. That's a game and probably two games for most receivers, or three games with 180 total yards.
And because the Raiders play so much man-to-man, they rarely double the outside receivers. They might think about the second half and changing that philosophy. We know that Woodson is playing hurt. He's helped out a couple of times, but he is just torching the single coverage of the Raiders in this first half.
Antonio Brown, combined with his running play, has outgained the Oakland Raiders on his own. Boswell to kick it off. Raiders have three timeouts to work with here. We've got 29 seconds left. This game will go through the back of the end zone. Raiders have it at the 20. Derek Carr, 8 of 17, 86 yards, two touchdowns.
It'll be interesting to see how the Raiders play this, needing about 60, or about actually 50 yards to get Janikowski in range. Janikowski in pregame warmups, kicking in this direction, hit the ball through the uprights from 57 yards out.
And they're not going to try it. Take a knee, and that'll do it for the first half. What do you think of that if you're Jack Del Rio and company, going conservative and just heading to the locker room?
I think on the road, and the way the Steelers have the momentum right now, good decision by Jack Del Rio.
And Oakland will get the football to start the second half, and that might have been part of the thought process for the Raiders coaching staff. 21-14, the Pittsburgh Steelers trying to get back over the 500 mark. They've got the lead on the Oakland Raiders. The Raiders looking for their third consecutive win. Just five teams in the AFC with a winning record: New England, Cincinnati, Denver, the Jets, and Oakland. Let's go downstairs. Evan Washburn. Evan?
Coach, that successful fourth and one call completely shifted the momentum. What went into that decision?
We're going to play to win. We're not going to play not to lose. We got to be aggressive. They're a good football team. We got to take the calculated risk associated with seeking victory.
Antonio Brown has torched them in the first half. How's he been so successful?
You know, they're playing one-on-one football like they play. We respect how they play football. They've been good at it. They've had a lot of success, but we can play too. So we're going to challenge them when they do that.
Appreciate the time. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, Evan, thank you. The end of the first half here in Pittsburgh. 21-14, the Steelers leading the Raiders. Verizon Halftime Report is coming up after this message and a word from your local station. This is the NFL on CBS, home of Super Bowl 50. The NFL on CBS getting ready for the start of the third quarter in Pittsburgh. 21-14, the Steelers in front. Now, Who Are You Lovin'? Presented by McDonald's. Game Time Gold. Roethlisberger to Brown. He actually said that a lot in the first half.
Well, he was targeted 14 times, got 10 catches, and here's D'Angelo Williams with his second touchdown of the first half. This is going to be a good finish, too. What do you expect between the Raiders and the Steelers?
Ian Eagle along with Dan Fouts, the rest of our CBS crew. Evan Washburn down on the sidelines. Important game. Oakland's 4-3. Steelers are 4-4. Could have wild card ramifications once we hit December and January. The obvious question: how do you slow down Brown if you're Oakland?
Well, you got to double team him at some point. Mike Tomlin just said that, that we're going to take advantage of their single coverage. But for the Raiders, let's see some more action out of Crabtree and Cooper. They both have a touchdown in that first half, but just five catches between the two of them.
So Antonio Brown, the story, 10 catches, 180 yards to lead Pittsburgh. The Oakland Raiders will have the football to start the second half. Raiders losses this year to Chicago, Denver, and Cincinnati. It's the 28th all-time meeting between these two teams. Raiders hold a 15-12 record that includes 3-3 in the playoffs against the Steelers. Boswell will kick it off. Tywan Jones is the deep man. Second half underway from Heinz Field. Jones will take it on the move to the 20. And Jones spilled out across the 25-yard line. They'll have it after the 26-yard return. Let's go downstairs, check in with Evan Washburn.
Well, guys, I spoke with Jack Del Rio, and I asked him, how do you slow down Antonio Brown? And he gave me a smile, saying, well, he's a great player, but they are going to look to double him more. He said they actually did double him some in that first half, and he's just so good that he was able to beat it. I asked about Woodson and whether him being out there hurt is hurting him. He said, we're going to let him fight through it. Likes what they're doing offensively, going to continue to try and run the ball. But it really comes down to their defense getting their offense more opportunities, guys.
And Evan, the play calls were balanced. 14 rushes, 17 passes. And this play whistled dead. Something that we haven't seen a lot. Flags. False. Just the second one.
Yeah, false start.
Offense number 77. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
It's Austin Howard on the right side of that Oakland line. First half numbers, 308 yards of offense for the Steelers. A 169 for Oakland.
Derek Carr, 8 of 17 for just 86 yards and those two scores.
Running play to Murray. And Murray hit from the side by Timmons. 2-yard pickup for Murray.
The Steelers have done a good job against the rush, allowing just 97 yards to their opponents. Murray, of course, had that beautiful 44-yarder on his first carry of the day, but since then he's only gained 30 yards and 10 carries.
White!
Till 2nd and 13. Shotgun for Carr.
50.
Just underway, 50. Second half in Pittsburgh. Again, it's Murray. And Murray lost his footing. He's brought down to the 25. It's a 1-yard pickup. Ryan Shazier will get credit for the tackle on the slip by Murray.
Well, Notre Dame and Pittsburgh, University of Pittsburgh played here yesterday. Field looks in good condition, but you often see visiting teams come in here and slip on this field.
Fighting Irish got the win over Pitt.
9-4! Hey!
Panthers made it interesting, though. Third and 12. Low snap, handled by Carr. Sets, and he throws to Murray. Murray, the ball pops loose. Oh, it's right there for the taking. Scooped up, Mike Mitchell hits the pylon for the touchdown. What a turn of events. Unless they rule him out at the one.
He was out of bounds, and then he came back onto the field and made the recovery. This is no touchdown. It'll be Pittsburgh ball where Mitchell recovered it, but because he was out of bounds and came back in, that will nullify the touchdown. Slipping again, Blake with another forced fumble here, actually coming in late there, is Shazier. You can see Mitchell out of bounds.
Yeah, great call there.
Timeout.
Mitchell circled around Murray to scoop it up. Pittsburgh coming up with the play defensively. Mike Carey has been monitoring this play. Mike, what'd you see?
Well, this is a complicated play. So in order for Pittsburgh to get the ball, the runner has to reestablish with 2 feet in bounds. He gets 1 foot in bounds, then touches the ball, which puts the ball out of bounds at that spot. It'll be Oakland's ball at that spot, fourth down.
All right, thanks so much, Mike. A lot happening on that play because Mitchell did take it the distance. Here's Bill Vinovich, official call.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field has changed. The recovering player did not get 2 feet in bounds. Therefore, he is still out of bounds. It'll be fourth down from the 21-yard line.
So two things at play here.
Game clock to 13:26.
No touchdown, obviously. No change of possession on the fumble. It's just ruled dead because Mitchell is ruled out of bounds. Murray lost the football, and the Steelers don't get the clean recovery.
Yeah, you can see that that left foot is out of bounds. Right foot is back in bounds. You have to get both feet in bounds.
He was one step away from Pittsburgh taking over. Instead, the Raiders avoid what could have been a crusher in this third quarter. King punting to Jacoby Jones, standing at the 29. It's blocked. The ball will roll for the Raiders.
Yeah, flag was thrown, but the ball clearly was blocked, so they'll pick up this flag for roughing the punter. Getting in was David Bud Dupree.
The ball is tipped.
24-yard punt.
And the rookie number one pick, Bud Dupree, number 48, is going to get this block as he comes clean, lays out, and gets just enough of that ball.
So the Raiders catch a break, but they can't do much with it. And they're fortunate the ball rolled the 15 yards from where it came down initially off the foot of King. 21-14, Steelers lead it. They take over at the Oakland 46. Early stages, third quarter. Running play for Williams going inside, and there is nothing there. No gain on the play. Stacy McGee in on that stop. And some pushing and shoving at the end of the play.
Darius Hayward Bay arguing with some former teammates.
Hayward Bay had left with a knee injury, so back in there for Pittsburgh. Hayward Bay was the number 7 pick overall of the Oakland Raiders in 2009. Then a stint with Indianapolis before signing with Pittsburgh last year.
Blue 80! Blue 80, sir!
Second and 10. Williams again. Williams squeezes through, but a number of Raiders ready for him. And it's a 3-yard gain for Williams. And we continue to have extracurricular after the whistle. It's 3rd and 7 now for Pittsburgh.
This is where you're supposed to say things are getting chippy.
No.
It's such an inappropriate word for what's really going on down there.
Steelers and Raiders, so much history through the years. They've met in the playoffs 6 times.
Hey, we're going Lenny! Lenny, 27,
great field position
Lenny.
Here for Pittsburgh. Can they take advantage of it, though? Line of scrimmage is now the 43 on a 3rd and 7 for Roethlisberger and company. Off the hands of Hayward Bay. Incomplete.
Boy, and Raider fans heard that for a number of years. Off the hands of Hayward Bay. It's a hook route, and he's open. Ball thrown away from the defense, but right through Hayward Bay's hands. They did double team Antonio Brown on the other side of the field and forced Roethlisberger to go to Hayward Bay.
The punt from Jordan Berry, no pressure. Marcus Thigpen waiting for it, fair catch called for. Sails back to the 10-yard line, and that's where the Raiders will have it, a 33-yard punt. 21-14, Steelers maintain the lead. Steelers 21, Raiders 14 with 11:31 to play in the third quarter. Oakland has it 1st and 10 at its own 10-yard line. Derek Carr is 9 of 18, 82 yards, 2 touchdowns. Latavius Murray, 75 yards on the ground. He can add to it here with a spin move and picks up a couple. William Gay there defensively, a 2-yard gain for Murray. Tuesday on CBS, one pill makes him a criminal's worst nightmare and the FBI's greatest asset. Don't miss a new episode of the hit drama Limitless. Tuesday at 10, 9 central, only CBS. Working quickly here, operating out of the gun. Play fake, over the middle, Amari Cooper took a hard hit and holds on to the football. A little slow getting up, 14 yards. On the play and a first down.
Yeah, shot by Mike Mitchell right to the thigh.
Mike Mitchell with the tackle
of Cooper.
First down Raiders at their 25.
So Seth Roberts will come in and replace Cooper. Rod Streeter is inactive. Andre Holmes last week had a pair of touchdowns in the win over the Jets. Now operating from the 25. Murray. Oh, what a run! Slashing to the 39-yard line. They'll mark him down at the 40. The blitz was on, and Murray just beat the blitz on a running play.
Well, let's look at the blitz. Here it is right here. This is Dupree, the rookie, number one pick. He's coming in a little bit too fast there. Gets the block. Good job by Gabe Jackson coming over there and pushing Dupree out of the way.
Raiders going no huddle. Play fake. Carr over the middle. Open man is Roberts. He's got the catch into Pittsburgh territory and brought down just short of the 42. It's an 18-yard pass play.
Well, and picking up the tempo has really got Carr in rhythm now. His last two passes got rid of that one quickly. And the Raiders have got something moving in the territory of the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Talked about that relationship, Carr and Musgrave. New system, new verbiage. Carr to the perimeter, Crabtree. And he's hit right away by Cockrell. 3-yard gain there. You know, Carr said, I have to learn coach's personality, his philosophy, and it happened early in the process. That was a big step in moving forward so that they could take this offense to another level. 8 straight completions now for Carr. On the ground, Murray doesn't go down initially and falls forward for a pickup of 2.
You know, it's another situation, we've seen this a number of times in this season, where your offensive coordinator is a former quarterback himself. So the relationship, the ability to have empathy for the position is very important. Musgrave was an outstanding quarterback at the University of Oregon, set a whole bunch of records for Marcus before Marcus Mariota broke most of them, winning the Heisman Trophy.
And bounced around the NFL as a backup for many years, 35 now. For Oakland.
Yeah, he backed up guys like Montana and Elway. That's not bad.
Not a bad gig. Carr sets it up.
Open! Roberts!
He's brought down shy of the goal line by Allen. He was that close to going all the way. 36 yards, and Carr looking so comfortable and under control in how he delivers the football.
This equals Roberts' longest catch of the season, and he's wide open before Will Allen can get over there. Another bust in the secondary for the Steelers. And the Raiders have answered. Where the Steelers couldn't take that advantage of that great field position. Carr had started 4 of 13, now 9 of 9.
6 offensive linemen. Hand it off. Murray trying to take it strong up the middle. And it comes up short.
Yeah, this is a case where being 6'3 is a disadvantage down on the goal line, unless you get up in the air and leap over the top of the pile. That time he did not lower his shoulder or leave his feet and was stood up right at the goal line.
Hayward and Timmons denying Murray.
Now!
Keith Butler hoping his defense comes up big in a goal line stand. Second and goal. Fake it. Carr, a flip to the end zone. Touchdown. He's got Wolford, the rookie Wolford. Gets the Raiders within one with 7:02 to play in the third. And Carr's got his third touchdown of the day.
And Wolford, his second touchdown of his young career. Gets beyond Shazier. And a nice soft touch from Carr on the rollout. It's just a beautiful throw, knowing he's got his man in the end zone for the score.
Last week, Carr became the first Raiders quarterback since Kerry Collins with back-to-back games of 3 or more touchdowns. He's now done it 3 in a row. 10 straight completions, Janikowski the extra point. We are knotted up at 21 apiece. The Raiders, 9 plays, 90 yards. And it's Carr to Wolford. We're all even in Pittsburgh. Derek Carr, first Raider quarterback with 3 or more touchdown passes in 3 straight games since our colleague, Rich Gannon, since 2001, 14-year stretch. They've been searching for a guy at that position. They found him.
Yeah, Eureka.
Jacoby Jones, return man. Matt Jones brought down at the 12 by Ray Armstrong.
Now Derek Carr, 14 of 23 for 154 and three scores. Here's his first one, a 22-yarder to Crabtree. His second one, a 15-yarder to Cooper. Then this gets the Raiders down to the one-yard line to Roberts from 36 yards, and then the soft toss to Walford. He hit his last four of the first half, his first six of the second half. He's a franchise quarterback, you bet.
Now Pittsburgh Steelers did not do well with the excellent starting field position on the last drive. This one, they're opening up at their own 12. Roethlisberger to throw it. Soft toss, caught by Miller. But a flag down. Flag is thrown at the 21. Miller turns and is hit by Mack.
And you might suspect holding here against the Raiders. Thrown in the secondary.
Last week, Steelers had 10 penalties for 91 yards. They don't have
illegal
one
use
today.
Of hands. Hands in the face. Defense number 29. 5-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
And it's called against Amerson, the third-year corner out of NC State.
And Amerson was working on Antonio Brown. Gonna rough him up a little bit, throw his timing off, and his hands up in the face.
Brown, the monster first half, 10 catches, 180 yards.
Hey, don't shit, Cody. That
Titan. So first down for Pittsburgh at the 17. Roethlisberger gets rid of it quickly. Trying to set it up for Bryant out in space, but there wasn't a whole lot of space to work with as Nico Thorpe sniffed it out. Mike Tomlin and Ben Roethlisberger talked about Martavis Bryant and the fact that he has to get more physical with the corners that he's going up against week in and week out.
Well, and he has the size to be more physical too. 6'4", 211 pounds. But he's young, he's learning.
Second and eight now for Pittsburgh. We approach 6 minutes to go in the third. Tied at 21. Shotgun for Roethlisberger and the play whistled dead. And this will be the first penalty of the day for the Steelers.
Bad time for it too.
False start. Offense number 72. Illegal snap. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
It's Cody Wallace in for Marquise Pouncey, who is on IR with an ankle injury. They were hoping Pouncey would return from that injury.
Hey,
had a couple of surgeries. Second and 13 now. Back at the 14-yard line.
Hey, run.
Steelers have scored over 30 points just once this year. They put up 43 against San Francisco in week two. Roethlisberger. Deep ball. Bryant can't hold on to it. Martavis Bryant had the step. And another juggle from Bryant.
Well, he had Thorpe beat by about 3 yards.
Third down.
But you'd see the difference between his ability to adjust to a ball over his head and over his shoulder. If he makes the catch cleanly inbounds, it's a long, long touchdown.
Hey, even with momentum carrying him out of bounds, it would have been a 50-yard reception. Instead, it's third and 13. Play clock winding down. They get the snap off. Protection holds up. Roethlisberger. It's intercepted. Amerson stepping in front for the pick. A chain of events for Pittsburgh. And a tough pill to swallow considering what could have been on the Bryant pass previously.
First pick of the year for Amerson. He does a great job of shadowing and cutting in front of Antonio Brown. Brown had no shot to get through the big defensive back, 205 pounds of Amerson there.
David Amerson, aggressive corner. Was originally a second-round pick of Washington in 2013. Jack Tatum trophy winner in 2011. And a soft throw by Roethlisberger trying to finesse it into Brown.
Bravo.
Raiders take over.
Down four.
At the 32 of Pittsburgh.
Monday, down. We're ready.
Motion man is Rivera. Take the handoff. Carr on the move.
Carr angles out of bounds. Picks up 4 yards of the scramble, chased down by Motes. JB and Boomer, NFL Today update.
Ian and Dan, I want to see how Boomer describes his pass play.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Sammy Watkins was chirping a few weeks ago about wanting the ball more. Well, he's got it more. How about this pass from Tyrod Taylor? Had 6 catches, 148 yards, 1 TD by Sammy Watkins. 12-point lead by the Bills, 26-14 over the Miami Dolphins.
Ian, I thought it was in the basket. Boomer said, ah, not quite.
He had a stretch for it a little bit, Jamie.
All right. Ian Eagle.
Electrifying talent, guys, and really it's just a matter of him staying healthy at this point for consistent production. On a pitch from Murray. Murray loses the football on the hit. Mike Mitchell didn't even know the ball was loose. Steelers claim they've got it. And they do. Pittsburgh takes over on the fumble by Latavius Murray.
Well, Murray had a lot of room to run here on this play, but Mitchell flying up and delivering the big blow. Came a long way. Murray still on the ground. Was much disappointed with the fumble.
The recovery by Jarvis Jones. So the stick by Mitchell, he turns around to celebrate. Meanwhile, the ball is sitting there. And Jarvis Jones jumps on top of it. Right now, the concern for Oakland is Murray. Latavius Murray was down for a long stretch. He took a hit from Mike Mitchell.
And watch the ball awareness by Mitchell. Right hand on the ball, pops it loose. And awkwardly twisted to the ground. And Mitchell showing tremendous sportsmanship here. John Latavius, hope you're doing okay.
Blue eyes, duck!
So the Steelers get it back at the 25. They give it to D'Angelo Williams. And Williams carries to the second level across the 35. It's a 12-yard pickup. Wallace and Gilbert with key blocks up front. Murray is up on his feet walking around.
Tight end Heath Miller as well on that right side. Good power by the Steelers. And positive way to start a drive after a turnover.
So I think they're going to check deeper into a potential head injury for Murray. Roethlisberger floats it for Williams, and he's got room. Williams across midfield. That Williams out of bounds, veers towards the sideline with a penalty marker on the other side of the field at the 48.
It's going to be holding against the Raiders, so Steelers will decline and take this 22-yard gain.
Prior to the pass, holding. Defense number 25. Penalty is declined. Result of the play. First down.
DJ Hayden called on the hold.
Yeah, trying to slow down Antonio Brown. Second time there's been a penalty in the second half here on somebody trying to stop number 84.
Shut up!
Jordan Todman is in. Play fake. Roethlisberger standing tall in the pocket. Tries to dump it off to Todman. It's incomplete. Justin Ellis putting the heat on Roethlisberger for Oakland.
Roethlisberger's so big and strong and oblivious to the chaos around him. He's got his own guys falling over him, being tugged and pulled by defenders.
Right, three down, right, right,
almost
right.
Threw a pick.
Right, three, right, right.
Most QBs in that situation, they're getting out of there.
They're throwing it away somewhere, far away.
Second and 10, Williams back in. Roethlisberger steps up in the pocket. He fires, and it's handled on the sideline. Catch made by Bryant. And it's good enough for a first down.
Yeah, the fans love it because after the catch, he didn't have enough for the first down. But he's going to use determination and strength here to pull away from Emerson just enough before the big hit comes over from Ray Armstrong. First down, Steelers.
Tall target, 6'4", 211 pounds. 6'11" would be really tall and probably not be playing in this game.
Or in this league.
From the 26, Roethlisberger sets it up for the deep ball. And it's over the head of Bryant. One-on-one with Hayden, second and 10. Pittsburgh continues to take deep shots down the field. And now Bryant is headed to the locker room. Latavius Bryant, Murray was trying to shake it off, and Murray has got to go into the protocol here after the hit from Mitchell. Let's check in with Evan Washburn. Evan?
Well, guys, as you can see, Murray heading in. They did take his helmet. They tested the neck and head area, and they brought in the UNC unaffiliated neurotrauma consultant. So as soon as I have an update, but it looks to be the protocol.
Second and 10, Roethlisberger. Low throw, incomplete. Brown, the intended receiver. We have 3:33 to go in the third in a tie ball game.
And you know who was lurking right there looking for Antonio Brown on that post route was Charles Woodson. Woodson does such a great job reading the quarterback's eyes, anticipating routes. 65 career interceptions. You just wonder how many he might have had if he had played safety his entire career.
Brown has been shut out so far in the third quarter. Pittsburgh having a tough time on third downs, just like 1 week ago against Cincinnati. This is a third and 10. Roethlisberger underneath. Brown catches it cleanly, but well short of a first down. Only 4 yards on the pass play. And it'll be Chris Boswell coming out for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, I like that defensive call by Ken Norton Jr. Bringing the blitz, forcing the hot throw, and then tackling after the catch. Big emphasis for the Raiders secondary. If they catch it, bring them down immediately. And that's what happened there.
This is a 41-yard attempt for Boswell. Boswell pushes it. His first miss as an NFL kicker. Jack Del Rio and the Raiders find themselves in a tight one in Pittsburgh. Boswell had a chance to put the Steelers in front. The Raiders welcomed 7-year-old Chase Delisle to their facility last Friday as part of the Make-A-Wish program. Chase had the opportunity to coach the team at practice and was on hand to watch the win against the Jets on Sunday. That means Chase is 1-0 as a coach. Carr throwing. He's got Cooper. Amari Cooper inside Pittsburgh territory to the 48-yard line. Jones and Blake combined to bring him down. 21 yards on the pass play.
Yeah, the relationship between Carr and Cooper growing by the pass. That anticipation by Carr that time got the ball out of his hand, dropped it into the dead spot of that zone, and Cooper was right there for the catch.
Carr told us Cooper's route running was so polished right away. He understands situations. He'll adjust based on what he sees instinctual. And Derek Carr is locked in right now. 11 straight completions for Carr. Carr steps and fires. Incomplete. Michael Crabtree, the intended receiver.
Sean Spence with a good job of taking away the inside on that route. Got down the field and ran with Crabtree. And that forced a very difficult throw. Watch 51 here. Little illegal bump there he gets away with, but because he had that inside position to help over the top, force that incompletion.
Latavius Murray is out as they are checking on a potential concussion. So Marcel Reese is in and he gets the carry here. Reese with a spin inside the 45, picks up 5, brought down by Tuitt.
Now Reese had that 12-yard run in the first half. Settles for 5 here, brings up a third down now for the Raiders. 4 of 9 in the ball game, converting third downs.
This is a 3rd and 5 for Oakland. We're down to a minute 38 and counting left in the third. Reese now sets up as a receiver. Will shift to the backfield on 3rd and 5. Carr swings it. Ball pops loose. Cockrell gets under it. And it's ruled incomplete. That's a live ball as Cockrell got there cleanly. Walford is down on the play after taking a shot. And medical staff's going to come out and check on Walford. Does Cockrell get there?
Nope.
It hit the ground. Barely, but it did.
Yeah, Will Allen with the big hit there pops it out. Timmons finishes him off. and the ball scrapes on the ground. You can see him lose control of it. Good job by the officials right on the spot here.
It actually bounced off the helmet of Timmons, and that's what pushed the ball in that direction towards Cockrell. Clive Walford, who has a touchdown here today.
You know, Franco would have had that.
That's true.
And he would have scored with it.
Trying to get the scoop underneath, but the ball clearly on the ground and moving. And a good sign, Walford is up on his feet and will walk off on his own.
Timmons with a big hit that time drove Walford to the ground. This is so typical of these two teams. Hard hitting, fierce battle.
Marquette King will punt it to Jacoby Jones. We have a minute 23 to play in the third quarter. Five punts, averaging 37.4 per kick. Jones moves out of the way, and the Raiders will down it inside the 10. Roethlisberger and the Steelers offense back on the field after the 34-yard punt. Week 9 continues later today on CBS and for some of you on Fox. Then tonight, Sunday Night Football on NBC, and tune in tomorrow, Monday Night Football on ESPN. So Walford is just trying to walk it off. He got his bell rung on that hit by Timmons. We're tied at 21.
33. Set.
So flip. D'Angelo Williams with Roosevelt Nix in front of him. Handed off to Williams. A cut by Williams leads to a 2-yard gain. Just across the 11-yard line, Edwards with another tackle for Oakland.
Short gain by Williams, but a smart move to get up the field. Tried to bounce it to the outside, saw nothing was there. And the veteran that he is, realizing you don't want to take a loss when you're already backed up.
We'll call it 2nd and 8 now for Pittsburgh. Under a minute to play in the third.
Blue 80. Blue 80.
Another run. Williams. To the outside. D'Angelo Williams. Down the sideline and forced out of bounds. D'Angelo Williams, it's been the fountain of youth. 53 yards. He had a 55-yard run last week.
Watch the block by number 45, Roosevelt Nix, and also DeCastro getting out in front. And then Woodson's going to come in and try to slap this ball out with his right hand. And he was slow getting up one more time. But Williams, great patience, letting the blocking develop in front of him. Sees Woodson from a long way coming.
19 carries, 114 yards, 2 touchdowns for the veteran D'Angelo Williams, 32 years old. We are all knotted up at 21 apiece going to the fourth quarter. Back to Pittsburgh after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS. We start the fourth quarter here in Pittsburgh. Some of the storylines here. Antonio Brown, huge first half. Derek Carr has been on the money for Oakland. And D'Angelo Williams stepping in for Le'Veon Bell, who's out for the season, has stepped forward. Murray out with a head injury. Jordan Todman getting the call on the first play of the fourth quarter. Picks up 2.5 yards, brought down by Stacy McGee. Todman, who had played with San Diego, Minnesota, and Jacksonville previously in his career.
Now it's just his second carry of the season behind Bell and Williams.
43rd career game. He made 3 starts as a member of the Jaguars. 2nd and 7, Williams. 114 yards and 2 touchdowns. give it to Brown. On the end around, Brown zigzags right at the marker. It's going to be short. Brown thought he had it. 6-yard pickup sets up third and one.
Watch the block by Heath Miller as he comes in reverse motion here and then gets out in front. He's going to chop the legs out here of the linebacker. Curtis Lofton, close but no first down.
Shut
up! So on third down, they give it to Williams. And Williams drives for the necessary yardage. 2-yard pickup, DJ Hayden with the pop. But Williams lunging more than enough to move the chains.
Yeah, he's bigger than you think. He's maybe only 5'9", but he's 207 pounds. Huge legs, great leg drive, and the smarts that time to go low to pick up the first down.
Originally from Wynn, Arkansas, D'Angelo Williams.
Off. Blue 80.
First down for Pittsburgh. Toss it to Brown. Antonio Brown gets tackled after a 9-yard pickup by Hayden. NFL Today update. We've got JB and Boomer.
A Buffalo on the loose, Bill.
JB, a healthy Sammy Watkins, a healthy Carlos Williams, and a healthy Tyrod Taylor equal a lot of points. 33, in fact, for the Buffalo Bills. They lead the Dolphins 33-14. They have rushed for 230 yards against this Dolphin defense thus far today.
Back to Ian Eagle.
And that's been such a huge key for Buffalo. When they've had their pieces in place, they've been effective offensively. But when E.J. Manuel has stepped in for Taylor, it's been an issue. Carlos Williams missed extended time with a concussion. LeSean McCoy has been trying to get healthy as well. D.J. Hayden was shaken up on the play. Nico Thorpe will step in for Hayden.
And that was a case of Roethlisberger seeing how far Hayden was off of Antonio Brown and just picking the ball up and throwing it out there as quickly as possible. 9-yard gain on the play, and maybe more importantly, getting DJ Hayden out of the lineup, forcing Thorpe in.
Thorpe is a former CFL standout, now in his third year from Auburn. Jim Thorpe Award winner back in his college days. They're checking on Hayden right now. This is a second and one. Roethlisberger is 2 yards away from a 300-yard passing day.
High 53, push, push.
Williams, single setback off to the side of Roethlisberger. He'll shift to the other side.
Nice slip.
Early stages, fourth quarter, tied at 21. Roethlisberger has the time. Roethlisberger will sky that one out of bounds.
It's just plain to see that Roethlisberger and Bryant still trying to get on the same page on some of these. Roethlisberger's so good at ad-libbing and finding ways to create big plays, as he's done so many times to Antonio Brown, that Bryant, just in his second year, still learning the quarterback's idiosyncrasies.
DJ Hayden is back in for Oakland. This is a third and one for Pittsburgh. Operating out of the gun, Roethlisberger tosses to Brown, and Brown has got enough for a first down. So they'll move the chains for the Steelers with a 2-yard pickup.
Darius Hayward Bay out in front here blocking as the ball is thrown. And Brown gets just enough to pick up the first down, keep this drive alive.
That is 13 catches for 194 yards for Antonio Brown.
Roethlisberger right at 300 yards.
Throw it out.
They place the football just inside the 15. Another quick hitter. Bryant.
Oh, what a move! Martavis Bryant!
Touchdown, Steelers! A video game-like maneuver.
Yeah, which move did you like? The first, the second, or the third? He hesitated just a little bit after he caught the ball to allow the blocking with Heath Miller out in front. Actually, that's James with a super job of taking out the interference, sends the hurdle, and then the sprint to the end zone.
He is a touchdown maker.
And And you wonder about the shoulder of Woodson. Woodson going low. And Bryant stepping right over the top.
Martavis Bryant, a red zone target. He is lethal. Extra point is good. The Steelers go 9 plays, 91 yards to break the tie. And it's Bryant put it on the highlight reel for the second year receiver out of Clemson. Pittsburgh 28-21 in the fourth. They are all riled up here in Pittsburgh. The Steelers lead it 28-21 thanks to the long scoring drive, capped off with a 14-yard highlight touchdown from Martavis Bryant. We've got 12-13 to play in the fourth. Boswell kicking it off to Tywan Jones. Moves up to the 10, and Jones loses the football! Bounces around! The Steelers getting down the field, and they come away with it.
Roosevelt next with the big hit on Tywan Jones. A killer turnover for the Raiders, but a great play by Nix as he uses his left hand to punch that ball out.
Roosevelt Nix in his first year out of Kent State. He was a defensive lineman in college. He's been playing fullback for the Steelers. Well, he can play special teams. Doesn't matter if you're offense or defense.
Jones holding the ball in his left hand, exposing it to the tackle, and that's what cost him. As Nix put his helmet right on the forearm, and the recovery by Ciccolo, Anthony Ciccolo, with the recovery for the Steelers.
So Pittsburgh takes over, first and goal at the Oakland 6. Last two games, the Raiders did not turn it over. They've coughed it up twice today. Williams picks a hole and gains 2. D'Angelo Williams has 2 touchdowns on the ground today, brought down by Ellis and Edwards for Oakland. Second and goal now for Pittsburgh from the 4.
All right, 3 down. Times.
Steelers trying to add to their lead. Working from the gun. Roethlisberger. Pump. Throw. Touchdown. Jesse James. Back in the end zone. First NFL touchdown for the rookie from Penn State.
First catch of his NFL career as well.
6'7". 221 pounds from Glassport, Pennsylvania, a fifth round pick, and he's got a memory that'll last forever.
Now Curtis Lofton thinking about Heath Miller more than the rookie James, passed him off to nobody in the back of the end zone. Roethlisberger gave him a nice toss for the touch.
Extra point is good. Boswell converts. Steelers force a turnover on special teams, and then they make the Raiders pay. This game has taken a turn in the fourth quarter. Pittsburgh has put up 14 points. They lead it 35-21. Mike Tomlin trying to get this team to 5-4. Jack Del Rio was attempting to get the Raiders to the halfway point at 5-3. That ball's out of bounds. So Chris Boswell boots that one out of bounds.
Number 9, the kicking team.
Raiders will have good field position to open up this drive. 11:24 to go in the fourth.
Let's go back to the touchdown and see exactly how the Steelers find James so wide open. Here he is lined up here, and here he is, Heath Miller. Watch Lofton here as they both release up the field. Lofton is going to help out on Miller with Malcolm Smith. And how about Jesse James? Remember, he got the key block on the touchdown pass to Bryant.
and playing today because of the injury to Spaeth, out with a knee injury.
Depth, so important.
Ow. Line of scrimmage is the 40-yard line. It's now a two-touchdown game. Carr, play fake. Carr pulls the trigger. And it's hauled in by Cooper. Amari Cooper defended there by Blake. 12-yard pass play for Oakland.
And Cooper really has the entire repertoire. The big body that time, he withstood the hit from Blake to make that catch and pick up a first down.
We asked Cooper about playing with Carr. He said he's very diligent in his approach to the game. A smart guy, just a great person to be around. He's confident in who he is. They've hit it off. Fake it again. Carr. It's complete to Roberts. Derek Carr. Excellent touchdown field for 19.
Yeah, a fadeaway pass, if you will. Pressure coming from the blitz. And Carr getting rid of it. Watch as he fades away on this throw and just puts it perfectly to Roberts.
Hey, Nick, let's go.
Now they are inside the Pittsburgh 30. We're down to 10:15 to play in the fourth. Carr will throw it. Releasing is Smith. Lee Smith is hit by Timmons on the sideline. Smith and Timmons. Okay with another competitive back and forth. Spot of the football will be key. Cooper, 43 catches this season. That ties Tim Brown for the most by a rookie wide receiver in franchise history. This is just the eighth game of the year for Oakland.
You know, that bad kickoff by Boswell has given the Raiders life, and they're taking advantage of that field position.
It is enough for a first down at the 19. Carr, handoff. Oh, look at Olawale go all the way. Jermaine Olawale, the backup fullback. Just caught the Steelers napping. Touchdown, Raiders.
Yeah, great cutback by Olawale. This was amazing, wasn't it?
It was.
Now behind the blocking on the left side, Gabe Jackson with a super job. Penn kicks out the defensive end, and Olawale goes untouched to the end zone, his first career touchdown.
Special team standout for the Raiders out of North Texas. Undrafted free agent who was on the Dallas practice squad at one point. Jermaine Olawale has cut the Pittsburgh lead to 7. Fourth quarter action continues from Pittsburgh, the NFL on CBS. We've seen contributions from unexpected sources today on both sides. Jesse James for Pittsburgh, Jermaine Olawale, the touchdown for Oakland. And it's 35-28 Steelers, 9:32 remaining in the fourth. Janikowski kicks it off. Jacoby Jones, newest member of the Steelers, lets that one fly through the back of the end zone. Steelers will have it at the 20. Well, your weekend starts with an AFC East showdown. Rex Ryan and the Buffalo Bills visit the New York Jets. Thursday Night Football on NFL Network. 6 years as the head man for the Jets. Jets have won 4 of their last 5 games at home against Buffalo. A lot of storylines brewing in that AFC East matchup.
It could be a little chatter coming out of Buffalo.
A little bit. That tends to be part of Rex's MO. 462 yards of offense for Pittsburgh. 6 offensive linemen here. Perfect. Roethlisberger. He's on time to Brown. And Brown has got a new career high. 15 yards on the pass play gives him 210 receiving yards on the day.
Now working against DJ Hayden. Timing between him and Roethlisberger has been absolutely perfect today. A good play action fake that time. Pulled the linebackers towards the line of scrimmage and allowed Brown to work freely over the middle.
Under 9 minutes to play now in this fourth quarter.
Set.
Luady. Luady.
From the 35. Williams. Cutting to the outside, D'Angelo Williams sheds a tackle. And Williams still going. Down at the 43. He made Ellis miss. He made Hayden miss. And he turns it into a 22-yard rip.
Now he's got the vision to cut all the way back to the weak side. There's the first missed tackle by Hayden. And now here's Charles Woodson again being driven back because of that bad shoulder and bad knee. But what a pickup the Steelers made when they picked up D'Angelo Williams.
Jordan Todman will come in and Williams will get a breather here with a first down for Pittsburgh.
Blue 20.
At the 43 of Blue Oakland. 20. Fake it. Roethlisberger steps up. Roethlisberger will toss this one to the Oakland sideline out of bounds.
Well, the Steelers were going for the bundle that time. Antonio Brown really was the only receiver on that side of the field. And he was double teamed as Woodson came over. Watch Woodson from the right side of the screen working in tandem with Amerson. And Ben Wisely tossed it into the Raider bench.
Antonio Brown has tied a Steelers record with 14 catches in a game. Courtney Hawkins back in November of 1998 against Tennessee, the previous mark. One more will give Brown the Steeler record. Roethlisberger extending out on Miller. And no penalty. Taylor Mays. He had 60,000 plus officials trying to make the call.
Well, Mays was all over the back of Heath Miller. But not until the ball got there. I think that's a good non-call by the officials. Ball also wasn't catchable. Thrown too far out in front of Heath Miller.
So now it's third and 10 for Pittsburgh. 7:51 to play.
Time.
5 out of 14 on third down conversions.
Time.
And a pivotal play here defensively for Oakland. Down by 7. Roethlisberger in trouble. He's dumped. Alden Smith gets to the quarterback.
And that hurt Roethlisberger. Remember that left knee? That's where he was trying to get out of the pocket. To the left side. Smith working on Villanueva. Just pushes the big guy back right into Roethlisberger. And he's going to grab for that left knee.
And the wingspan of Alden Smith. Roethlisberger. He can't put any weight on it.
Yeah, he twisted his ankle, it looked like, too. Look at that left foot there being pinned underneath. So it's not the knee here. Rather, it's the foot. Back in college, I suffered a similar injury when the balls of my feet hit my heel, bent just like that. I'm not saying he's got a broken foot, but it certainly is sore.
On fourth down, Jordan Berry will punt it. It's returnable. Thigpen spun down. Hayward Bay got down there. Jamarco Thomas, 48-yard punt.
That's tremendous play on special teams, but more concerning is the health of Ben Roethlisberger as they're checking out that left foot. Watch his left foot here. Smith's going to come down right on top of it.
Now Roethlisberger knew it right away. And he needed help.
There's a lot of time left in this ball game too, but the Raiders have a long field to go to try to tie this up.
7:12 remaining.
We're waiting. What's that?
Reese extended action with the injury to Murray. And he's brought down by Allen. 3.5 yard gain there for Marcel Reese. Oakland is going deep into their skill positions. With NFL Mobile, stream live, local Sunday afternoon primetime games and NFL Red Zone right on your mobile device. Learn more at NFL.com/mobile.
One of the Raiders' offensive linemen is still down back at the 6-yard line.
Now that's Rodney Hudson, who has emerged as the leader of this Raiders O-line, signing that 5-year, $44 million deal during the offseason from Kansas City.
And does Derek Carr ever appreciate the intelligence and athletic ability of Rodney Hudson? As he reads coverages, he knows coverages, he calls them out, takes a huge load off the quarterback's plate. But now, with Hudson going out, Roethlisberger heading to the locker room, we're not going to see Ben Roethlisberger the rest of this day.
334 yards, 2 touchdowns, and a pick for Roethlisberger. The backup today is Landry Jones. Mike Vick, inactive. He's been dealing with a hamstring injury. Send it down to Evan Washburn with more. Evan?
Guys, not much to report except it is the left foot. They did some test deflection of it. They had some conversation with athletic trainers and doctors. Could put no weight on it, put him on the cart to take him into the locker room. As soon as I have more, I'll let you know.
Raiders take over at their own 11-yard line. We've got 6.5 to play. Carr, play fake, out of the pocket. Carr, skies one in the air. Crabtree can't haul it in. Incomplete. McClendon put the heat on Carr, and Roethlisberger on the cart.
That ball might have been able to be caught by Crabtree on the sidelines. I wonder if he was concerned about getting his feet in bounds because he failed to do that earlier in this ball game. Huge third down coming up for both sides.
Hey, 94, 94, 94. Oh, you got me?
Third and 6 for Oakland. Working from the gun. Carr hooks a pass offline. Crabtree, the intended target. And it's fourth down for the Raiders with 6:18 to play.
Working against Antoine Blake. Number 41 against number 15 here. And Crabtree just a little bit slow coming out of that break as Blake was looking to take away the out route. Crabtree pivoted back to the inside.
The punt coverage of Pittsburgh helped set this up. Initially getting down the field on special teams, and Oakland now kicking out of its own end zone. Antonio Brown is the return man. Marquette King gets it off cleanly, booming kick. Brown backpedals from the 39. He loses the football. It's free.
Raiders got it. Looks like Tevin McDonald.
Oakland takes over. Antonio Brown coughs it up. Actually, on the return.
Yeah, and it's Ray Armstrong, special teams ace. Brown trying to make a move here, never really got the ball. Now he's got it, and it's punched out.
And for a moment, Brown got his hands on it, but he could not bring it into his body. And Jack Del Rio pumping the fist. The Raiders are in business in Pittsburgh territory, down by 7.
Is that Jamaze Olawale with the punch out?
Raiders will have it at the 39-yard line.
Looking to try to set up the return here.
No, it was Andre Holmes.
Great play by Holmes.
Holmes knocking it free on his way around Brown. Shotgun, Carr. Downfield, he fires a bullet to Crabtree. Antoine Blake back there. It's a 12-yard gain.
Carr really has all the skills you need. Throws well from the pocket, but I've been impressed with how well he's been throwing, almost in a dead sprint that time, to his right to find his receiver along the sideline.
Raiders have it at the 27 now of Pittsburgh. They trail by 7. Fake the pitch. Carr flips it Incomplete to Cooper. Second and 10 for Oakland. 5:27 remaining.
Arthur Motes with good pressure that time. As Keith Butler, defensive coordinator for the Steelers, dialing up another blitz.
Second and 10 for the Raiders. Five receivers set for Carr to work with. Carr to the outside. Cooper tried to make a move. Three Steelers are there defensively. Blake and Allen, first two over there, to limit Cooper to a four-yard pickup.
Good read by Carr. Saw the blitz coming to that side. And again, Blake playing off of Cooper allowed that short reception to bring up a third down now and six.
Third and six for the Raiders. Under 5 minutes to play. Pittsburgh holding on to a 7-point lead. Carr steps up. Carr's pass bounces. And a flag is down.
And they hit Carr low. This is going to be a penalty against the Steelers.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense number 50. Low hit on the quarterback. 15-yard penalty.
Raiders kept Rivera in the backfield to block along with the fullback Reese, but you can see the low hit. And that's Shazier trying to hustle to get to the quarterback, and that is a personal foul.
Huge call at the 4:41 mark. Ben Roethlisberger, left foot injury. That's why he was carted off for Pittsburgh. The Steelers' focus right now is on the defensive side of the ball, just the second penalty of the day against the Steelers. First roughing the passer penalty of the season for Pittsburgh. First and 10, inside the 12. Carr gets rid of it. It's a high throw over the head of Walford. Incomplete. Arthur Motes sharing a laugh with Derek Carr.
Yeah, he says, I'm getting closer to you is what he's saying. That's two blitzes now on this drive that have caused a couple of incompletions. Good pressure by Motes.
Raiders have been playing without Latavius Murray after taking a jarring hit in the third quarter to the head from Mike Mitchell.
Hey, failed there. 94.
Second and 10 for Oakland. Shotgun for Carr. Carr lost it. End zone. Upstairs, Cooper. Out of bounds.
What a great throw by Carr. Double coverage on Cooper in the end zone. Look at this effort. Right foot in, left foot out. Yes, right on the line. Could not drag the left foot or this would have been a Raider touchdown.
He was that close.
That big toe is out of bounds.
And it brings up third and 10 now for Oakland. What a battle in Pittsburgh. 4:31 to play. Shotgun for Carr. Carr fires. End zone. Intercepted. It's picked off. Ross Cockrell will take it out for the Steelers. The Raiders turn it over in the fourth.
Well, the choice by Carr to go to Clive Walford cost him. Obviously not on the same page. Walford beat on the play. Cockrell comes away with a huge play for the Steelers.
The Steelers defense coming up big.
Let's go back to the interception by Ross Cockrell. Here's Cockrell. Here is Roberts. And here is Walford. Walford comes down and kind of slows, but look at the vision here by Cockrell. Cockrell's playing zone coverage here, lets Roberts go to the corner. Walford stops on his route. Carr expecting him to continue, picked off.
And Landry Jones is in the game. He hands it to D'Angelo Williams. Ben Roethlisberger out with a left foot injury. 1 yard gain there for Williams, hit by Curtis Lofton. This was the hit on Roethlisberger, Alden Smith. Roethlisberger went down right away and grabbed at the left leg. As we saw the second and third replay, you could see that the foot hyperextended. And now it's Landry Jones who takes over the offense. Obviously, Ben coming off the knee trouble that cost him four games. Steelers are 2-2 in those games. Jones got the final start against Kansas City. Play clock is down to one. And the play is whistled dead.
Yep, timeout, Steelers.
First charge timeout.
Sideline saw that the time was running out on the play clock and didn't want to take any chances. Tomorrow on CBS, the only thing smarter than a genius is a team of them. Catch an all-new Scorpion tomorrow at 9, 8 Central, only CBS.
It'll be interesting to see how much faith the Steeler coaching staff has in Landry Jones. He's got three touchdown passes on the year, two interceptions. He's been sacked twice and fumbled one time in limited action in relief of Roethlisberger.
High-pressure
situation here.
Fourth round draft pick in 2013 out of Oklahoma, left there as the Sooners' all-time leading passer, a four-year starter. Jones, he does throw it. It's complete, Antonio Brown, and that's a new Steelers record. His 15th catch of the day, the most ever for a Pittsburgh Steeler in one game.
Well, you can see the off coverage by Amerson, a little stutter step there by Brown, great quickness there. 15 catches, 224 yards for Antonio Brown. And good choice by Landry.
And it keeps the drive going now for Pittsburgh. We are at 3 minutes to play in the fourth. Oakland has all three timeouts remaining. The yardage record in the game for Pittsburgh is held by Plexico Burress, 253 against Atlanta in 0-2. Jones again. Antonio Brown down low to get it. It's a modest gain of 3 yards. And the clock stops with 2:41 left. Oakland has used the timeout. Derek Carr, 20 of 37, 232 yards, three touchdowns, but a costly interception here in the fourth quarter. Ben Roethlisberger carted off in the fourth quarter with a left foot injury. Murray left the game in the third quarter for Oakland after taking a hit to the head. And Antonio Brown having a career day with 227 yards on 16 catches. We've had five turnovers between the two teams in the second half. Oakland has two timeouts remaining. Motion man is Miller. Give it to Williams, and he's tossed down. 1 yard pickup, another timeout used at the 2:36 mark. Mario Edwards in on that stop.
Yeah, so important to use your timeouts before that 2 minute warning. So much easier once you get the ball back, obviously, for your offense to be able to control the clock. You should notice D'Angelo Williams with both hands on that ball as he approached the line of scrimmage.
Stay tuned. NFL Today update presented by FanDuel. Time permitting, JB, Tony, Bart, Boomer, and Coach Cower. Latest NFL scores and highlights. And plenty of them here in Pittsburgh. 2:36 to play. Steelers 35, Raiders 28. Landry Jones stepping in for the injured Ben Roethlisberger. And it's a 3rd and 6. If they get the first down here, Pittsburgh could take the clock near the 30-second mark, taking into account the 2-minute warning and the one Oakland timeout remaining. Huge play on a 3rd and 6. Jones out of the gun and flags come down.
Different cadence from Landry. Jones and then different from Ben Roethlisberger's cadence.
Ball start. Offense number 72. 5-yard penalty. backfield third down.
So back it up. Now third and 11. Three penalties against the Steelers.
And two of them have been on false snaps by Cody Wallace.
From the 39, it's a third and 11 for Pittsburgh. From the gun, Jones steps up. Jones on time. Antonio Brown gets the first down. Flag is thrown at the 44. Tevin McDonald could not bring him down. The fake by Brown, and he dances for a first down.
This might be a pick, though, against the Steelers and bring this one back. Crossing route, you always got to suspect an illegal pick.
Pass interference. Offense number 11. 10-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
It's Marcus Wheaton. And the Raiders will get another chance to stop Pittsburgh.
Here's Wheaton, and he's going to come down, block on Hayden, and now we lose him in the picture there. But he absolutely took and peeled off the defender that was covering Brown on his crossing route.
It was third and six. It's now third and 21. And if you're Pittsburgh, you don't take any chances, I would think. Just run the football and trust your defense. Let's see what Todd Haley has drawn up. Working out of the gun, Jones. Pump, toss. It's offline at the feet of D'Angelo Williams. And that stops the clock.
And that's huge.
If you run the football, at least you're forcing Oakland's hand, either using a timeout or letting it go down to the two-minute warning. So 22 seconds, you give that to the Oakland Raiders on the incompletion.
And he had time to throw. It was just a three-man rush by the Raiders that time. He hurried the throw and threw it way behind D'Angelo Williams. Inexperienced by Jones.
Barry will punt it. Thigpen waiting for it. Fair catch. At the 31, 40-yard punt. The Raiders have to go 69 yards to tie this game.
And they'll be able to stop the clock twice with the two-minute warning and one of their timeouts. Plenty of time and plenty of weapons for Derek Carr to use.
He has thrown the football 37 times today. Three touchdowns for Derek Carr.
Hey, we're going 94.
Two 15 to play, 35-28 Steelers. Do the Raiders have a rally in them? Carr settles in the pocket, throws to Cooper, and he's tossed out of bounds by Cockrell.
But tossed backwards, so the clock will continue to roll here. It will not stop because when he went out of bounds, he was heading back towards his own goal line.
It's a 9-yard gain. We've hit the two-minute warning. 7-point lead for Pittsburgh, trying to hold on at home against Oakland. Coming up next, Peyton Manning and Andrew Luck square off. The undefeated Broncos take on the Colts right here on CBS Sports. The situation here in Pittsburgh. Steelers lead it 35-28 over Oakland. It's a second and one for the Raiders. Cooper could not secure it. A drop ball for Amari Cooper. Ryan Shazier over there defensively. And it's now third and one for Oakland.
Yeah, a little slant route. Good fake by Carr to get the defense up. And Cooper looking to run. Fourth drop pass today for the Raiders.
.157 to play.
Hey, Larry, Larry, Larry. Hey, Larry, Larry, Larry.
On third and one for Oakland. Carr, pump. Carr, the dart. It's caught for a first down by Rivera. Out near midfield, it covers 8 yards. Raiders have one timeout to work with here. We're down to a minute 42 to play. in a 7-point game.
Yeah, great throw. Just a flick of the wrist to get it to Rivera.
Carr tosses downfield. Incomplete. Rivera fell down on the play, and the closest player to it was Antoine Blake for Pittsburgh.
James Harrison trying to come over in coverage may have watched number 92 here. They're going to get their feet tangled up. That's a good non-call there. But Harrison did look like he kicked out with his left foot to contact the feet of Rivera.
Stops the clock with a minute 31 to play. From the Oakland 48. Second down for the Raiders. Out of the gun. Carr into a crowd. Incomplete. Tried to get it to Andre Holmes. Antoine Blake deep for Pittsburgh.
Well, Blake had that huge interception last week against Cincinnati and a 70-yard touchdown return of an interception against San Diego. He had a better shot at this than Holmes did. Watch him avoid contact, go for the ball, and not be able to pull it in because Timmons is right there.
Hey, 94, 94.
On third and 10.
Steelers left the blitz on third down.
Play clock is down to two. Movement flags down. Carr fires to the sideline. Hauled in by Crabtree. And a stiff arm on Blake out of bounds. Penalty marker back at the 45 on Oakland's side of the field.
Raiders saying it's against the Steelers.
Offside, defense, penalties declined, result of the play, first down.
So it's a free play for Oakland, and they take full advantage on the completion.
Carr just looks like a polished veteran in these pressure situations. And a good job of getting the Raiders now into Steeler territory. A lot of time left.
1:21 remaining. Oakland has one timeout left from the 38. Carr lofts it in the air. Oh, it's caught by Crabtree. Touchdown, Raiders. You can't throw it any better than Carr just did. 38 yards. Oakland an extra point away from tying this one up in Pittsburgh. Carr has gone over 300 yards. Derek Carr has looked like a star.
Crabtree getting behind the secondary that time. And with the pressure bearing down on Carr, as you said, just an absolutely perfect soft toss for the touchdown.
Pittsburgh will still have a minute 15 left and two timeouts, but no Ben Roethlisberger. Extra point is good. Janikowski. We are tied at 35 apiece.
You know, the other thing about before the throw, he saw the coverage. He saw he had a linebacker, Timmons, trying to stay with a wide receiver. And also, Timmons had his back to the quarterback. Quarterback's mind, he says, there's nobody there. He can't see the ball. And also, being able to deliver under pressure as he gets hit. And remember, it was the low hit by Ryan Shazier that brought the personal foul penalty that kept the drive alive for the Raiders.
We have no idea what the result's going to be here, but the one thing that's become obvious, Oakland has turned the corner as an organization. They have a bright future.
And it's because of those two fellas and Amari Cooper, see about Latavius Murray's injury, but also the coaching staff that Jack Del Rio has assembled. Ken Norton Jr. on the defensive side coordinating that, and Bill Musgrave. Doing a great job with young Derek Carr. Really well-coached team.
And now the pressure shifts to Landry Jones, the third-year quarterback, stepping in for Ben Roethlisberger. Jones, the return man, he's not going to touch it. The Steelers will have it at the 20 with 1:15 on the clock and two timeouts.
Let's go back to the touchdown. Here is Lawrence Timmons, and here is Crabtree. And Crabtree is just going to outrun him right down the field. Great read by Carr, and you can see Timmons no match. Man, Timmons is a big old linebacker, 234 pounds, and looky what I've found.
And
six
Dan,
points.
From the Pittsburgh point of view, you've got a young quarterback, you've got a young kicker. And you need 3 points to get a win and avoid overtime. 1:15 to play. Jones operating out of the gun. Handoff. D'Angelo Williams up the middle. Finds the hole. Williams with a flag down. He got hit from behind across the 40-yard line. 20-yard run for Williams. Is it coming back?
Yes, it is. This was a late hold, too. As Williams had broke through the line of scrimmage, then the flag came out.
He had done most of his damage already.
Offense number 83. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat, first down.
It's Heath Miller called on the hold as we check in with Evan Washburn.
Guys, an update on Ben Roethlisberger. He has left the stadium for further evaluation on that left foot.
Roethlisberger took a hit in the fourth quarter from Aldon Smith. And since that point, it's been Landry Jones in at quarterback. First and 7. It goes down as a 13-yard run and a 10-yard penalty. Jones in the pocket, throws to Miller. And Miller is out of bounds, short of the first down. 5-yard pickup, 1:02 to play.
Now the career-long kick, and it's been a short career for Chris Boswell. It's 51 yards. He had a 34-yarder today. And we got a Raider down. And again, it's DJ Hayden.
Well, he's had a tough day. He's worked hard trying to go against Antonio Brown. And he's been knocked around a couple of times as well. So Miller anticipating the hit from Hayden, who went down low, and it was Hayden that took the brunt of it.
Yeah, right on his shoulder there. Miller goes about 260 pounds. Hayden about 190.
And Oakland loses a timeout because of the injury. .102 left. Steelers and Raiders are tied at 35. Another look at the Roethlisberger injury as Evan Washburn just reported Roethlisberger has left the stadium. Smith fell on the back of Roethlisberger's left foot. Hayden is on his feet. And the Steelers face a 2nd-and-2 at the 28. As you mentioned, Boswell, the long is 51. Tomlin has been reluctant to try longer field goals with Boswell.
And he turned down a 52-yard attempt in the first quarter. Elected to go for it on fourth down and were turned away by the Raiders.
The wind right now is non-existent. 2nd-and-2 for Pittsburgh. Operating from the gun, Landry Jones dials up a deep ball. Jones down the sideline. Incomplete. Trying to get it to Bryant. And guess who? Charles Woodson. 65 career interceptions. Nearly had number 66.
A lot of contact with Nico Thorpe here, but watch Woodson come over. Lay out. Ball goes right through his hands. Todd Haley deciding as the offensive coordinator and play caller to give Bryant a shot way down the field, but Woodson still has great range, sideline to sideline.
So it's 3rd-and-2 now for the Steelers.
There's some issue with the officials now.
And Mike Tomlin looking for an explanation. .55 seconds left on the clock. So Tomlin satisfied with what Bill Vinovich had to say, and we'll see Landry Jones in a 3rd and 2 with a tie game, 35 apiece. Now Jack Del Rio wants to know what's going on as well. Bill Vinovich.
Hello.
The chains were inadvertently moved. It'll be 3rd down and 2 at the 28-yard line.
Well, they had the chains back at about 3rd and 4.
We've had it as 3rd and 2 since the penalty after the run by Williams. It was the hold that brought it back, and maybe the chain gang didn't have it correctly.
Well, on one side of the field, they had it like 3rd and 4. And now they've corrected it on both sides.
They need to get to the 30-yard line to keep this drive moving. 55 seconds left to play. There have already been 2 overtime games today in the NFL. We might be headed to a third.
Let's go down! For the 3, for the 3, right, right, right!
On 3rd and 2 for Pittsburgh. 17 catches, 284 yards. Your Landry Jones. Yeah, let Brown do the work.
Well, he's got the entire repertoire. Catches in the crowd, the deep ball, the run after the catch.
Denver and Indianapolis coming up here on CBS. Still some work to be done. D'Angelo Williams, 5 yards to the 10. We're down to 35 seconds left.
Watch Marcus Wheaton here. He got called for pass interference earlier in this quarter. This is not pass interference, but he forces Amerson to go around him, and that gave Brown the freedom to go down the sideline.
You know, you could look at it the other way and say that Oakland should have let Brown score. But you're not thinking that way. D'Angelo Williams is. Williams forced out at the 1 by DJ Hayden with 4 seconds left. D'Angelo Williams has stepped forward today for Pittsburgh. 170 yards, 2 touchdowns. Le'Veon Bell out for the season. 4 seconds remaining.
About 597 yards of offense for the Steelers today.
And Boswell is on, looking for the win. Greg Warren will snap it. Jordan Berry is the holder. A 19-yard chip shot. And a flag down.
And final timeout, Pittsburgh. 30-second timeout.
So Steelers use the timeout. Normally you don't like to ice your own kicker.
Well, you know, the time was running down, but I might have taken the delay of game penalty just to move it back a little bit to improve the angle. Remember, Boswell has missed today a rather short field goal.
Four seconds left. 19-yard attempt. Looking for the win. Raiders pointing in Pittsburgh's direction to throw the flag.
False start.
And now they'll back it
up. Offense number 78. 5-yard penalty.
And Del Rio wants to decline the penalty to make sure this is a sharper angle.
That's exactly what he's done. So they're not going to give Boswell any more
Oakland has
room
to
work
decline
with.
The penalty.
Where they're spotting it, we're going to call it an 18-yard attempt.
It's about as short as you can get.
From 18 yards away. Boswell, the first year kicker. The kick, he's got it! The Pittsburgh Steelers back on track. A much needed 38-35 win over the Raiders. Pittsburgh outlasts Oakland. The question is whether or not they're going to put a second on the clock here.
No, they should, because it was such a short field goal. Ball got through the uprights in less than 4 seconds.
We had triple zeros on our clock, and it looks like they're going to put 2 seconds up.
A chance for a kickoff return.
Yeah, there's 2 seconds. This thing isn't over yet.
But you saw that Miami Duke game, did you?
I did. I did. Strange things can happen.
Yeah, and so can suspensions.
And part of the problem was Steelers thought it was over, and a bunch of players left the field, ran through the tunnel. So now Pittsburgh will kick it off with 2 seconds on the clock. The second the ball hits the net, the clock is supposed to stop.
Well, it should stop once the ball goes through the uprights. There's officials standing right under the uprights. They should see when it goes through.
Agreed.
And the clock should stop, because the nets are different distances in different stadiums.
Absolutely correct. Either way, 2 seconds remain on the clock here as Boswell will kick it off. He'll put this one on the ground, and it's scooped up at the 15-yard line. Footpath. Lateral, ball bouncing around, the Steelers have it. There will be no miracle for the Oakland Raiders. Pittsburgh 38, the Raiders 35. The Steelers improved to 5-4. Oakland is 4-4. Big win for Pittsburgh. For Dan Fouts and Evan Washburn, I'm Ian Eagle. So long from Heinz Field. You've been watching the NFL on CBS.